Sacramento reports the department filed an application for a new $300,000 Stingray cell site simulator in August of 2013. Stingrays work by tricking cell phones into sending data to the devices as if it were a cell tower. Despite evidence that the department is using the tools, no requests for search warrants have been made. The Liberty Beat is sponsored by the Texas Bitcoin Conference. Hear from speakers like Charlie Shrem, Dr. Robert Murphy, Vitalik Buterin, and Catherine Bleich. March 28th and 29th at ACL Live at the Moody Theater. Tickets on sale now, texasbitcoinconference.com. Support also comes from Central Texas Gunworks, your online source for firearms, firearm accessories, and ammunition. They take major credit cards and now accept Bitcoin. Visit them online, shop.centraltexasgunworks.com. This is the Liberty Beat for Friday, February 13th, 2015. Check out the website at thelibertybeat.com. Former intelligence analyst and whistleblower Chelsea Manning has been granted approval for hormone treatment for a gender transition. Officials with the Department of Defense stated the therapy was approved on February 5th. The announcement follows a lawsuit filed in D.C. last September where Manning stated she was at risk for suicide if not given treatment for gender dysphoria. Manning is currently serving a 35-year prison sentence for leaking classified documents to WikiLeaks. First Nations people of Southeast Alaska are facing threats to their traditions and way of life from large mining operations. The United Tribal Transboundary Mining Work Group and Haida Indian Tribes of Alaska are calling on the state of Alaska and the U.S. State Department to stop destructive mining operations, including mines in British Columbia, such as Red Chris, until further studies are conducted. The groups are calling for bans on water tailings dams in response to a recent engineering report on the causes of a recent spill. The report highlighted shortcomings in designs and maintenance. The Liberty Beat is made possible by CoinArch, offering innovative trading solutions for Bitcoin. Do more than just buy and sell Bitcoin. Use long and short positions to profit in rising and falling markets, and to boost your returns through leverage. Visit CoinArch.com and sign up using coupon code MAX and get free brokerage for the first 7 days. That's CoinArch.com. Support also comes from Midas Resources Incorporated, helping clients convert their paper 401ks and IRAs to solid gold and silver. Get their 10 Reasons book free by calling 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237. This is the Liberty Beat for Friday, February 13th, 2015. I'm Brian Hagan, reporting, reminding you, spread liberty with a smile.
Tomorrow's my big day. I'm going to go in for surgery, and hopefully you'll come along. Now, I do have to admit that I am in a bit of pain, so I'm really looking forward to this procedure. I think we're both going to find out that having surgery just isn't as scary as it sounds.
We're covering our own Jim Haggerty's kidney stone removal surgery, and his surgery is now just minutes away. So, Dr. Atkins, tell us what precautions we would take to prevent us from getting kidney stones.
Always stay hydrated. Water helps the kidneys break the stuff down.
Hear that, Jim? More water.
What?
More water. Maybe we should replace your coffee.
Please go away.
That's a camera they're going to use to film the whole surgery from inside Jim's body,
right? Yes, that's going to be pushed into Jim's urethra as well. Now, normally they wouldn't do this. This is purely for the benefit of us watching it on TV.
All right, stick with us, because first he's going to pop into the children's ward to cheer up some youngsters suffering from terminal illnesses.
This is the Onion News Network.
This is Free Talk Live. We're doing a live Saturday edition of the program. You can dial in toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And you can join us online over at freetalklive.com. All the features that we give to you on the site, they are for free, so enjoy those on us. Again, freetalklive.com. We've got Skype here in the studio tonight. If you want to call in on Skype, you can do that via username lrn.fm. So feel free to reach out in that way. Of course, our toll-free number is also available to you at any time, which is toll-free 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Joining you here, it's Ian.
And Mark.
So there's news about this 50 Shades of Grey, Mark, and I have to say I'm not real familiar with this product, but I do know that it is a phenomenon.
That's right.
That the book was a bestseller, a big-time bestseller. The movie is now on track to be the number one movie this weekend in the United States, according to Variety. It opened to $30 million on Friday alone, on its way to a projected record-breaking $76 million long weekend. If estimates hold, the R-rated pick will easily dominate the previous President's Day weekend record holder, Valentine's Day, for the best showing ever for the holiday. Okay. So it's on track to make quite a bit of money. The critics
are going to be getting spankings for holiday and for Valentine's Day. Is that what you're claiming?
Well, that's what this movie is apparently about. It is apparently about some level of S&M. Would that be accurate?
Yep, I think that's so I hear.
People getting kinky. And apparently America has a bit of a fascination for this. And I guess I'm wondering, you know, where does it come from? Does the fascination that people have with 50 Shades of Grey and whatever it is, you know, whatever sex acts that it's portraying, does that come from the fact that America is a relatively puritanical place when it comes to sex? And so therefore people are more likely to sort of act out, if you will, in ways that are deviant. I'm not saying I have a problem with people doing this. I mean, if that's what floats your boat, then by all means. But I wonder how many of the people...
If it's that big of a movie, is it really a deviation?
Well, that's a good point.
I mean, is it those of us that think that we're normal, are we the deviants?
Yeah, well, good point. I mean, the definition of deviance is to deviate from the norm, whatever that means.
Right. I've heard that sort of domination... fantasies are as common among women as two gals' fantasies are for men. And if that's the case, that's a pretty darn common fantasy.
So, yeah, I guess I'm wondering, you know, who's going to see the movie? Is it, you know, is it men and women equally? Is it mostly women who are interested in this film? It seemed to be a book that was marketed towards women. But, you know, again, like I said, I'm not intimately familiar with the content of this particular product. So if you are a fan of 50 Shades of Grey, would love to hear your story. You know, what got you into that? Were you into... kind of BDSM or dominance submission stuff prior to 50 Shades of Grey?
Or is it just well written?
Yeah. I mean, I don't know. I'm just curious. I just figured, you know, it's in the news. I figured I'd throw it out there. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Obviously, we're doing talk radio, so we can't get too detailed on certain
too explicit,
kinky, sexy things, but we can still talk about these things.
But, I mean, a lot of people have... taken the opportunity of this movie doing well and this book series doing well to, you know, play amateur psychiatrist for, you know, the people that like it or whatever, or to get up on their soapbox and push their particular, you know, brand of social politics or whatever it might be. So I find that sort of an interesting phenomenon, too. I can exist alongside 50 Shades of Grey without it causing me any kind of angst or upset. You know, like, okay.
Why would it? Why should it?
Well, because people are spanking each other and having fun doing it. If you wanted me to get on a soapbox about it, like you suggested that it was a puritanical because the United States is puritanical. That's you getting on a soapbox. That's you using this movie to sort of push your agenda. I would, however, say that this might have something to do with the use of corporal punishment among children.
That it's manifesting in sexual proclivities?
Yeah. I mean, mm-hmm. I think that kids imprint at a certain time as far as sexual preferences and that sort of thing. And spankings are, by their very nature, they are unique and important aspects of one's life, especially when they're occurring. So, you know, there's some studies that show that people who participate in, you know, bondage and BDSM and all that stuff are... I guess bondage is BDSM. So BDSM are, you know, have, you know, that's related to corporal punishment.
So that there's a correlation.
Yeah,
what you're saying.
I was corporally punished, and I don't have, you know, these particular proclivities. Not my thing.
Yeah, I'm more of I have a proclivity against it. And, you know, if somebody asks me to do something that is of a what I consider to be violent nature in the bedroom, that's something that is not attractive to me. I find that to be weird. Like, I'm not interested in hurting my partner. I want, you know, my partner to feel good. But then again, this does feel good for some people, right? Like that's part of the attraction, is that it's, you know, a sexy thing to do, apparently, for some folks. So I'm just throwing it out there because I'm curious, you know, what makes this thing, this movie and book, what makes it such a phenomenon? Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Is it because Americans don't talk about these issues? That these conversations, for instance, aren't generally had on talk radio and, you know, in the workplace and over the dinner table? People are, in the United States, not generally comfortable talking about sexuality. And so, you know, does that mean that people are more likely to fantasize about these things quietly on their own and that this book plays into those fantasies? I'm speculating here. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. I was trying to pull up RottenTomatoes.com, but the site appears to be down at the moment. But when I was looking at it earlier, it looked like the tomato rating, as it is called, is in the 20 percentile, which is not good. So that means that, I don't know if you're familiar with Rotten Tomatoes, but they collect different reviews from around the web and they come up with a tomato rating. They decide whether or not a reviewer is a fresh tomato or a splat.
Yeah.
Of a tomato, and then they average numbers together and they come up with a percentage as far as, you know, how many reviewers liked this movie. Apparently about 20-something percent of reviewers liked this movie. That doesn't mean it's a bad movie. That just means the reviewers didn't like it.
I do know the movie sprung out of fan fiction of a series called Twilight. And
really?
Yes.
The teen series?
Yes.
Okay.
With the werewolves and the sparkly vampires?
Huh. Yeah, I mean, I'm generally familiar with it, but I...
And that isn't known for its depth and, you know, high critical review. So, I mean, I think that as...
This isn't a book aimed at teenagers. This is an adult book.
No, right? It's not. It's fan fiction written by, I believe, a 51-year-old. So, no, I would agree that that is not fan fiction aimed at...
Wait, what you're saying is... Hold on. You're saying that 50 Shades of Grey is fan fiction?
50 Shades
of
Grey.
About the Twilight universe?
Started out as fan fiction in the Twilight universe.
Huh.
Yes, I believe it was Edward, I believe, is the vampire. I shouldn't be talking, though, because I really don't know. Maybe I'm identifying there's probably a bunch of teenage girls who are screaming at their radios right now because I've misidentified the vampire versus the werewolf. I have no clue. I really don't.
So, yeah, that's what I'm saying. I don't know either. I just, you know, saw this topping the box office and thought this thing is a phenomenon. It's worth talking about. Why is this thing so popular in the United States? Will it be as popular worldwide as well? I mean, in Europe where...
This ain't an era in India. Not a place where, you know... Kissing in Bollywood is a pretty much a rarity, as I understand it.
In Europe, though, I mean, they're generally considered more sexually open than the United States. Will a movie like this be as popular in a place like that because people aren't as sexually repressed? Your thoughts are certainly welcome. You can join us toll-free at 855-450-FREE. 50 Shades of Grey, whether you've read the book or you've seen the movie or you're planning on seeing the movie, what is the motivation? And does your interest in this particular fiction reflect your sexual proclivities, or is it more of just kind of a fantasy? Like, you've never actually acted these things out, but somehow you're gaining some level of satisfaction by fantasizing about that. You're welcome to share your thoughts. Also coming up, a middle school student had the FBI called on him for throwing the American flag out of a window. Is that right, Mark?
Yes.
Did I get that right? We'll come back with all of that. Your thoughts are welcome here. We're live on Saturday night. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. 855-450-3733. More Free Talk Live coming up.
Shiny badges on your jacket. Shiny badges. Yeah!
This is Davi Barker from shinybadges.com, and I just want to personally apologize for airing a jingle week after week, month after month, that turned out to be such an infectious brain worm. So to make it up to you, I'm offering a free gift. The next time you make a purchase at shinybadges.com, write "worms" in the transaction comments, and I'll send you something weird.
Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
On the average, Americans work between 45 to 50 years, hoping to build up enough wealth to retire and live out their golden years. Unfortunately, with taxation, the rising cost of food, energy, housing, and medical, many retirees are forced to live below the poverty line. Is this a flaw of free enterprise, or is our monetary unit we call the Federal Reserve Note forcing us into perpetual debt, ensuring inflation and higher taxes? These questions and more can be answered by reading G. Edward Griffin's book, The Creature from Jekyll Island. Congressman Ron Paul states it's what every American needs to know about central bank power. A gripping adventure into the secret world of international banking cartel. Hi, this is Ted Anderson. I will give a silver dollar from the early 1900s to anyone who purchases this book. Call 1-800-686-2237 and order a copy today. It's critical that the public be made aware of the system. Call and order your copy today at 1-800-686-2237. That's 1-800-686-2237.
Are you looking for an excuse to come check out New Hampshire this fall? You're invited to Keenvention. Keenvention is your chance to meet dozens of key liberty activists from across the Shire. You can explore the beautiful little city of Keene, discuss various forms of activism with seasoned veterans, do some Robin Hooding, and learn about making the move. Keenvention received rave reviews last year. If you missed it, visit keenvention.info for full video coverage of every speaker and panel. This year's keynote speeches and panels will be announced via the Keenvention blog and Facebook, so stay tuned there for the latest. Join old and new friends and neighbors in Keene for Keenvention this October 30th through November 1st. Tickets are available now at a special super early bird price of just $40 via credit card or Bitcoin. That $40 price only lasts through early March, so don't delay. Reserve your tickets now at keenvention.info. Visit keenvention.info for more and look for our page and event on Facebook. That's keenvention.info.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are: one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love, but make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
When I found the Free State Project, I knew it was the key to achieving liberty in my lifetime. It's awesome to be surrounded by like-minded, freedom-loving activists who've moved here to New Hampshire. From politics to civil disobedience, we have it all. Where I came from, it felt that no matter what I did, liberty was dying. Perhaps you feel the same way? Call 888-377-2515 now to learn more about the Free State Project. That's 888-377-2515 or visit freestateproject.org.
You can interact with other LRN listeners in our message board at forum.lrn.fm. That's forum.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. It is a live Saturday edition of the program. You can, of course, bring up anything you'd like to discuss. I was just curious as to what people were thinking about the 50 Shades of Grey, not necessarily the movie or the book, either one, if you'd like to comment. If you're a fan, especially, would like to know, you know, what is it that's inspiring to you to make you interested in this particular product? It seems like there's quite a bit of popularity surrounding it, and I'm just wondering why. What is it about BDSM, domination, that is so attractive to people in the United States? 855-450-FREE. And how did you get into it? Because, Mark, you suggested that maybe it was people who are spanked. Maybe that makes someone more likely to have a proclivity towards this particular interest.
Something I've read.
The sexual fetish. And just curious, you know, what's your story? 855-450-FREE. Also, we've got a story about a young man in trouble for throwing the American flag out of a school window. the FBI apparently was called in on that case. Plus, I want to let you know how to get a pound of some of the best coffee out there from BuzzBox. You go to coffee.freetalklive.com. It's shade-grown, 100% organic, and top 1% grade Arabica. It's great coffee, and they're doing great things over at BuzzBox. We've teamed up with them to allow microloans to be handed out from some of the profits that come in from this great coffee, which, again, you get the first pound for free. You just pay the shipping cost by going to coffee.freetalklive.com. But again, the profits are going out to people in tough parts of the world that are they're trying to make a living, trying to start a business, maybe improve their existing business. And it's hard to get loans. It's hard to even bank in those parts of the world. So Kiva.org is helping with that, and we're teaming up with them. So when you buy coffee from coffee.freetalklive.com, not only are you getting great coffee, but you're also helping people out worldwide. And so go to coffee.freetalklive.com and help people's make better lives for themselves and enjoy some really great coffee. You get the first pound free just by paying the shipping cost at coffee.freetalklive.com. We got Brian. He's in Myrtle Beach listening to WRNN. Hello, Brian.
Hello.
Hey, Brian. You're on the air.
Thank you. I have to say I've not read the book, but I know several women who have. And if you guys have not read it, and subsequently with the release, I think just today, not even seeing the movie, and you're querying on the why is it so hot and big deal, I think part of it may be that, well, seemingly there hasn't been anything like it in a while. But if you go way back to the era of, say, like the Marquis de Sade, where something that got a wide release, that was such a taboo topic, and there's probably lots of writings over the millennia that would be similar. In this society today, through digital media, et cetera, more people know about the subject matter more immediately, and therefore go, let me get in on that.
So you're saying that the 50 Shades of Grey, had it come out 30 years ago, maybe wouldn't have been as big of a phenomenon due to the absence of social media?
Possibly, and not just social media.
Because sex stories have been around for a long time, and romance novels have been around for a long time, but this thing has become a phenomenon.
Point. Yeah, that was my point. You know, I'm not hanging their success on social media as much as, you know, if you get a book and you find, not you specifically, but someone in general, and you really latch on to what it's all about and how great it is, then you get on, you know, Facebook, Twitter, whatever. I just got this book. I think it's really awesome. Ooh, it's really hot. And if it's something that hasn't been seen in a while, because, yeah, we do have romance novels coming out of our ears, but if it's something that's just it's different, it's got a hook to it, the next thing you know, you're on your social media telling all your friends and girlfriends, you're at the water cooler, and somebody even says, oh, so-and-so said this book was great. Maybe I'll check it out.
Yeah, that's why I think it's probably pretty well written, is because mm-hmm. there's no shortage of romance novels out there, and I'm certain that they have more and less of this sort of thing going on in them, depending on, you know, I'm sure they have the different genres for different preferences. But that's why I get the impression that this must be a pretty well written series or book.
Is it a series?
I would not disagree. I mean, I think there's obviously something about it that's just like a good pop tune. It's got a hook.
Mm-hmm.
It's saying something, or it's saying something in a certain way that is reactive to people. I've actually heard in certain circles some male associates who have said, if you haven't read this book, you need to look into it because the women are on fire for it. And now I think it's maybe...
Why is that, though? I mean, is it just because it's a good write, a good read and entertaining, or is it because that it's tapping into something that is, you know, something that people typically don't talk about or acknowledge or want to acknowledge?
Yeah, and I really don't know, because they don't really want to get too deep into the conversation after sure. they make the suggestion.
Thanks, Brian, for your call tonight.
I've not read it.
I appreciate it. Thank you for the call. I'm sure there's somebody out there who has read it. It's incredibly popular. The movie hit $30 million just yesterday. I guess it just came out. And so you're welcome to share your experience with us here at 855-450-FREE. Enlighten us, those of us who are ignorant as to how good this book really is. I mean, it
I think this is, you know, like a dirty secret to some extent, and people don't want to share it. And the reason is because, well, I mean, everybody's got their theory as to why this stuff is done, and it's all sort of paints it in a bad light, right? Have you said anything that other than, yeah, people are free to spank each other on the bottoms if that's what they want to do, but what was your reasoning behind it? It's really because America's repressed sexually. And
I'm not saying that,
but everybody's
that's true.
Got their thing. No, I'm just saying everybody's got their thing. I'm not saying that you're, you know, being a particular jerk about it. I'm just saying that just sort of this book, you know, everybody's got their explanations as to why BDSM is a thing, and none of them paint it in a particularly good light, right? Hmm. I mean, if there's this many people going to this movie to see it, then it must be a pretty good movie, and they must have some kind of affinity and attachment to this kind of thing.
Well, just because people go to see a movie doesn't make it a good movie necessarily. I mean, the critics are saying this is terrible, but that doesn't necessarily mean it's a bad movie either. Just because the critics don't like something doesn't necessarily mean that it's bad.
I saw Jupiter Ascending again, and I'm still recommending that.
Let's go to Eric. He's in Newton, Iowa. Eric, you're on Free Talk Live.
I was just wanting to put a little input in on kind of the whole BDSM life.
Sure.
I mean, it's one of those lifestyles that people have always kind of had a taboo against, and it's one of those that gets looked down upon on a lot of things. But, I mean, it's just something some people really enjoy. I mean, especially some of the people that are like in charge of people all day that typically want to be controlled somewhat in more of a sexual fantasy way.
So hold on. I have heard this before. Are you saying that people that it tends to be that powerful people like to get their bottoms spanked? Is that what you're saying?
Well, it's not necessarily that like to get their bottoms spanked,
but they tend to want to be dominated.
Exactly.
Yeah.
And I'm not saying that everybody is that way.
No.
I mean, obviously not.
I've heard that too, but... and I really love the idea of politicians getting getting smacked around by their wives.
We actually heard that directly from a dominatrix back about, it's been probably like a decade since we had her on to talk about it. But Miss Anne, back when she was a dominatrix in Indianapolis, came on to tell us just that she had these powerful people under her whip. But there's more coming up here. Eric, if you got more to share, stand by. We'll come back to you. It's Free Talk Live.
Hunters, anglers, campers, and survivalists, get back to nature. Expand your horizons with the highest quality, most versatile, unique slingshots and sling bows on the market at slingbow.com. Slingbow products are compact and models start from just $17.98. They're perfect for your bug out bag or storing in your vehicle. Give yourself and your loved ones the excitement and tradition of slingbow, a new frontier in archery and truly modern twist on this primitive survival tool. Feel the thrill only at slingbow.com.
It's no secret that government and big business buy in bulk and get huge discounts not available to the little guy. Until now. Introducing a breakthrough crowd buying website where people can join together, buy in bulk, and get massive discounts on millions of popular products. It's TogetherSave.com. TogetherSave.com. You can save 20, 30, or even 50% off tablets, smartphones, cars, appliances, textbooks, sports equipment, video games, and much more. All with free delivery. Check it out. TogetherSave.com. Visit now and start group buying today at TogetherSave.com.
Jack Daniels announced today its plan to start marketing directly to children, adding, quote, why not? Executives for the whiskey company told reporters that they've already slated dozens of television spots showing 10-year-old children drinking tumblers of Jack and Coke in playgrounds, and that the company was planning, unquote, just seeing how it all played out.
Every year, Jack Daniels sells millions of dollars of great American whiskey to men and women all over the world. So, for our next ad campaign, we basically just thought, hey, why not just start marketing this stuff straight to 10-year-olds? I mean, if they catch us, they catch us, but we'll see how far it goes, and hopefully we can sell some alcohol along the way. Sure, some parents' groups could get upset, especially if we go with our idea of moms serving their kids cranberry jack at snack time, but...
In other news, a doomed rabbit will teach an 8-year-old a lesson about responsibility, and a torrent of soap issues from a wildly unexpected part of the dispenser. Well, that was it. It's all downhill from here, bud. For more, visit theonion.com.
This is the Onion News Network.
This Your Family. Daily Today tip is brought to you by Nestle Toll House Morsels, helping you create special moments and memories your family will cherish forever. Visit us at tollhouse.com. You may bake for birthdays and holidays, but why stop there? Sweeten up the rest of the year by designating monthly dessert days. Treat your family to one of their favorites or surprise them with something new. Either way, you'll create a tradition everyone will love. For more tips like these, visit us at parenthood.com/yourfamilytoday.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone. 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308. What if the key to achieving liberty in your lifetime was to move together with others who think like you? Liberty activists are joining the Free State Project, which is over 70% of the way to its goal of 20,000 participants. And they're already making the move to New Hampshire. The successes are piling up and are proving the Free State Project is a real movement and no longer just a great idea. When you're planning your move, consider Keene. Keene is famous for its civil disobedience and non-cooperation, and there's plenty of political opportunity as well. From demonstrations and vigils to outreach and volunteering, there's a lot going on in Keene. Keene is the liberty media capital of the world, with television, talk radio, and more, all originating here. Though it's more than just activism, with regular social events each week. See what's happening at freekeene.com and get connected with video, audio, free books, a forum, and activist tools you can download and use in your area at freekeene.com. That's freekeene.com.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live, the live Saturday edition, continuing here. We'll take your calls about whatever you'd like to discuss. You just dial on in toll free at 855-450-FREE. And, of course, you can join us online anytime at freetalklive.com. Also over at vegas.com, you can get 10% off of everything you see there with the exception of air hotel packages. Vegas.com serves up Vegas from the inside because, unlike other travel sites, they're actually from Vegas, the right. people that work there.
Yeah, I think it's pretty. When you go to Vegas, you can often sort of you can pay full price. There's no problem with that. But finding the deals and that kind of thing is very difficult when you're a sort of an outsider. It's nice to that they they're from there and they know what's going on.
Yeah, they work in Vegas, they live in Vegas, and they party in Vegas, and they know the people that set the deals. The second the prices drop in Vegas, Vegas.com drops them on their site. In real time. Plus, they've got the proprietary drop watch tool, which actually will monitor the price even after you book and notifies you of changes to ensure you get the best deals. So they've got your back.
That's pretty cool that they're going to check out the deals for you. They're going to make sure if the prices change that you get the better deal. That's impressive.
Vegas.com has the best rates on not just hotels, but also headliner shows, tours, attractions, even VIP bottle service at top clubs. Vegas.com, when you use code FTL, that's how you get that 10% off. Already they've got great prices.
Well, you've already got the best prices because they're living right there. And then you get 10% off of on top of it.
Yeah, as long as you're not selecting an air hotel package, everything else 10% off over at Vegas.com by using code FTL. That's like FTL, like Free Talk Live. Just put that into the promo box at checkout to knock that other 10% off over at Vegas.com.
But they do have hotel packages and then sort of everything else. They have all those packages. So it's really just the air and hotel combo packets, right?
That the air hotel combo packages are the ones that are not valid for the 10% off, but everything else on the site is.
Okay.
So just use code FTL at Vegas.com. Our toll-free number here tonight is 855-450-FREE. We were talking about the 50 Shades of Grey movie, and actually, Mark, apparently this is a trilogy. I thought that it was just one book. But I guess the book is what has been translated in. The first book is what has been turned into the movie that has just come out and is
any successful book is a series, right? I mean, you wouldn't just leave it at one.
Yeah, well, that's generally a true statement, I suppose. So they apparently already came out with both of the sequels, so all three books are already available, and I don't know if that means that three movies will be coming out, but I imagine if it does commercially, you know, have success, as it appears to be having...
The answer is then yes.
You can expect that more will be coming. So I just... The question that I'd asked earlier was, what's the fascination? Why is it that people are so interested in this? Is it that there's a latent... obsession that people have with BDSM, with dominance and submission, and you know, those sorts of sexual proclivities or fetishes. You're welcome to share your thoughts here, and if you are into that, can you pinpoint how it started? Because I know that there's a guy I know who explained that he got into getting tied up when he was a young boy, and he was interested in magic tricks, and he tied himself up as, you know, as Houdini might, or something like that, going to put himself in a straitjacket sort of tie-up situation. And he was alone, I guess, during this at home. And
tying yourself up alone probably isn't a great idea.
Trying to escape the ties. And during that time, he sort of was rubbing himself around on the floor and managed to get an erection off of that. And that landed him into squarely into the category of somebody who's really into being tied up.
Hmm.
And so... just an interest as a boy in magic tricks led to being having a sexual proclivity about being tied up against his will.
It may be a story he's telling himself to some extent, because basically he wanted to get tied up, right? Because he tied himself up.
Yeah.
And then...
because of magic, though.
Well, so he had an interest before he was terribly sexualized. He had an interest in getting tied up. And then as he gets sexualized, what a surprise, he had an interest in getting tied up and then sexualized it.
Hmm. So where does it come from? Is it something you're born with, or is it something that you acquire at some point during your development as a young person or a young adult? So feel free to share your experience. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Also, you can bring up anything you want. Alma is in Georgia. You're on Free Talk Live. Hello, Alma.
Hey, sweetie. I want to talk about Iran, but first I'm going to say, you're still not on the radio here on the weekends, and reason it irritates me, I have to take my son's internet to listen to you, because Saturday and Sundays is when I love to listen to you. It's nothing going on. And my husband likes TV. He likes to get on the computer. So I'm
well,
in
just
there.
So you know, Alma, I did check last
did
week, because you called on Sunday night expressing concern that we were off the air in Tallahassee. Our show is on the air on weeknights.
During the week, but
from,
not the weekend.
9 to midnight. So.
And that's my favorite time, excuse me.
Well, what I would suggest that you do is you can contact your local radio station and let them know you'd like to hear more Free Talk Live, and, you know, be nice about it. And be nice about it.
I'm very nice, because I can't get him off the phone.
Alma, what do you think about 50 Shades of Grey? Are you familiar with this?
I think it's filthy from what I've heard of it.
Filthy.
I don't like filth.
Filthy.
Now,
wait a minute. Wait. Now, what is filthy about it? I mean, it's just people with riding crops and spanking each other, right?
I mean, really want me to get down and explain it to you, do you now?
Well, I mean, we can't get too detailed as far as, like, you know, things that happen during sex, but...
you know, God made us. He made us in his image, and he made us to be decent. That's Satan's image when we get filthy. Okay,
is it filthy, though? I mean, what's filthy about a good spanking? As long as it's consensual. I mean, that sounds clean.
No, when my daddy and mama, my daddy whipped me with a belt. It come out.
So now that's not okay. That's wrong to my mind, because you didn't want that to happen. It's not consensual. Spanking's parent to child, not okay.
That's what I think of. That means
I see
pain.
What you're saying. So that's
it.
So because you were abused as a child by your father, that means to you that people who engage in similar behavior consensually, sexually, somehow
it
bad.
It means it's disgusting. I want someone to cuddle me and love me and tell me how much they love me.
I'm with you there. I prefer that level of intimacy myself.
Yeah,
I don't understand it personally, but that's why I'm asking the question tonight.
I don't want to be mistreated. No one wants to be mistreated.
See, now, I think that's interesting, because to me, what Alma's saying sounds like sort of a healthy relationship to sex. But, you know, I think that these other people probably believe they have a healthy relationship. So
they're sick. They're demon possessed. They're sick.
Well, I don't think that's a nice thing to say, but it's your opinion,
know,
and you're entitled to it, Alma.
I'm so nice, and y'all are not either. I'm just giving you my opinion.
That's fair enough. Thanks for the call tonight. I appreciate it. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. I don't look down on it. I mean, everybody's got their thing. I just wonder where these things come from. Were you born wanting to spank someone or be spanked? Or does that come about from some sort of interaction that you have or something that happens to you along the way?
Well, it's the old nature versus nurture argument.
Well, she was spanked and it turned her off toward that sort of thing. You were speculating earlier that maybe there was a correlation between people who were spanked and interest in BDSM. But maybe the ball, you know, the pendulum swings both ways on that.
I couldn't tell you. But, you know, some people are born with the proclivities to do different types of things, and others just kind of move into it.
Well, it's certainly true that people are, in my opinion, born gay. I think there's a lot of evidence for that. I mean, if you talk to folks who are gay, they will tell you pretty clearly that they always knew it and that, you know, it's been that way since day number one. They've been attracted to people of the same sex from the very beginning. So if that's true, and I believe that it is, then can that also be true of sexual fetishes? You know, are you born with those things? You can share your experience with us here. 50 Shades of Grey topping the box office already this weekend with $30 million in one day, which is a pretty big take.
Yeah, it's a pretty big take.
Any movie. And from what I read, the budget of the film was only $40 million. So in one day, they've already made back almost the entirety of the budget.
It's huge.
Likely by the close of business today, they will have turned a profit on this particular movie. So you can expect to see more of them coming, more likely. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. But what is the fascination? And I don't agree with Alma, by the way, that it's dirty or anything like that. I mean, unless you're bleeding during it, that could be a little unclean, I suppose. 855-450-FREE. More coming up. You can share your thoughts. We've also got Skype. Skype in at username lrn.fm. It's Free Talk Live. Have you thought about owning gold? There are lots of reasons to own precious metals. A hedge against inflation. When the dollar tanks, metals go up. A barter currency. You can disempower the Fed by using real money. And no one knows the future. In an economic collapse, metals are likely to be a currency. Do as I've done for years. Buy your gold and silver and precious metals from Midas Resources through gold.freetalklive.com. That's gold.freetalklive.com. Here's a good idea. When you have a legal matter like creating your will or legally setting up a business with a corporation or LLC, you don't necessarily need a law firm. Use LegalZoom.com. At LegalZoom.com, you answer straightforward questions online and they take care of the rest. They even review your answers for common mistakes and guarantee your satisfaction. Free Talk Live listeners, you'll get 10% off your order by typing in FTL in the referral box at purchase. Don't procrastinate with these important legal documents. LegalZoom.com.
This alert just came in. This special announcement is for business owners and leaders of organizations who've been waiting for the right time to build. General Steel has made it impossible to wait any longer with rock-bottom prices that could save you thousands. That's right, General Steel, America's leader in pre-engineered structures, is offering buildings at prices you will never see again. Don't miss these prices. A 50 by 100 for $35,000. You heard right. That's 5,000 square feet for $35,000. Manufacturers, if you need a larger building, try a 100 by 100 commercial building for $129,000. You can't afford to rent with these prices. Imagine a 70 by 100 foot church building for under $69,000. With the economy improving and interest rates still at historic lows, you can't afford to wait. So call 866-91-STEEL. Lock in your price now. Call 866-91-STEEL. That's 866-917-8335.
Since time began, tyrants have taken aim at personal liberties. Now there's a movie that aims back.
The government has no more right to tell us what to put in our bodies than they have to take our guns or tell us what books we can read.
Six drug police were eaten by bears while raiding a marijuana farm.
On your knees, you dirty hippies!
Jesus.
On your knees!
What's the
problem, officer.
Today, many cops who enforce pot laws do so only because it provides them with cushy jobs, good benefits, and a chance to push people around.
I was an undercover narcotics officer. The drug war is nothing but a farce.
The Second Amendment says you got to keep you and your gat intact.
Guns and Weed, The Road to Freedom. A film by Michael W. Dean and Nima Vadavi.
DVD available now at gunsandweed.com or on Amazon. That's gunsandweed.com. Makes the perfect gift. Remember, that's gunsandweed.com.
Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
Are you a political activist who does things that the government might not like? Then this free ebook may save your life. Rats is your guide to protecting yourself against snitches, informers, informants, agents provocateur, narcs, finks, and similar vermin. Rats was written by OG libertarian Claire Wolf. Rats is a short book, easy to read, and available free in many formats. Download Rats free at rats-nosnitch.com. That's rats-nosnitch.com.
You can put the Liberty Radio Network on the air in your area. Visit broadcast.lrn.fm to learn how. Broadcast.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. Dial toll free to bring up what you'd like at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We consent to you calling the show and talking about anything you want. And that's, of course, the most important thing. I don't think that what people who are interested in BDSM are doing is dirty, like our last caller suggested. She said it was of the devil or whatever. I don't know. Some people are into that, and it seems harmless so long as everyone's consenting to what's going on. Of course, they have the safe words, which is a way to indicate to a partner engaging in BDSM related activity that things have gone too far and you're no longer in your comfort zone and that it needs to stop. So there are ways for people to remain at as safe as possible when engaging in certain behavior.
Yeah, what I heard from Alma was that she thought that it was a poor choice, not that
she said it was of the devil. She said it was demon possession. Yeah, I mean, that's, you know, that's a little different than saying that's a poor choice, right?
Well, I think that's, you know, it certainly, if it was a, if I believed in the devil, then I would consider doing things of the devil to be of a poor choice. I'm not a big believer in that. So there you go.
So you can share your thoughts here. We've been talking about 50 Shades of Grey from a position of ignorance, honestly. I don't know that much about it. Mark, you kind of gave me a little information that it was apparently originally based on some fan fiction regarding the Twilight series. It's become an international, probably international bestseller, definitely a national bestseller, and it's now spawned a movie, which is taking the box office by storm this weekend, apparently. We'd love to get your thoughts on, you know, where the interest comes from in this particular fetish. Let's go to Tom, listening in Madison, Wisconsin, to the Mike 92.1 WXXM. Hey, Tom.
Hey, I guess the devil compels me to call in then. This is the first time I've ever called into a radio show, so I'm going to try not to stumble over myself.
You're doing fine. Go ahead.
First, I haven't read the books. I think it's just wrong to read the books because they're Twilight fan fiction, and that's just a terrible series. But I have very religious friends who consider it pornography, and so they're not going to watch the movie, and they haven't read the books.
I would say that if you're going to go by sort of, you know, what normal definitions of pornography are, I would say that it was pornography. I don't have any particular, like, I have no emotions around that, but yeah, I would say it probably fits a definition of pornography.
I think by the SCOTUS's decision, it's considered pornography. But from my friends who are in the lifestyle, who have read it, and from several reviews I've read of the books portray not a BDSM relationship, but an abusive relationship between a man and a woman.
Okay.
So that's another thing, another reason that I won't see it. But I'm in my 30s now, in my mid-30s, and in my 20s, I was briefly involved in the scene. And I don't think it was something I would have sought out. It was a group of friends that I'm still friends with that invited me to a party. And now I wasn't exactly sure. Like, I kind of had an idea of what was going to go on. But
turns out it was a spanking party.
It was. And I put my fears aside and I went and I walked in the door and my hostess said, these are the rules. Everything has to be consensual.
On your knees.
You have to have a safe word, and you don't do anything you don't want to do. And if you're not clean, don't partake in anything that's going to, you know, give someone else a disease.
Right.
And I wouldn't have done it if I didn't trust the people. Everyone there was all smiles throughout the whole thing. You had to give permission for someone to draw your blood by scratching or whatever, or whipping, but the most anyone got were welts.
How many people were at this party?
Yeah, sounds like a great party. What the hell was going on?
There were more than a dozen. There was a massage table set up for kind of a tortuous massage. Mm-hmm. But the thing about it was you could so easily get into it because my fear, you know, made my adrenaline just shoot through the roof. And the whole thing about it is you do it the right way, it's more pleasurable than it is painful.
Hmm. Well, certainly,
I would suggest if anyone wants to experiment, take a clothespin and put it on your nipple and leave it there until it's numb and then take it off and see what happens.
That just doesn't sound like fun for me. What you're saying is that the wait through that pain is worth the feeling of the relief at the end?
Absolutely. Absolutely.
I'll take your word for it.
I don't suggest someone go out and get a flog and start doing that sort of thing, because it can be dangerous if you don't know what you're doing. Take a whip and...
Yeah. So, but you said that this party that you went to didn't result in you embracing the scene completely, right? Like that it wasn't enough.
Well, I ended up getting in a relationship shortly after that, and she was, you know, into the scene. She also didn't know the people. If I hadn't known them.
Let me ask you
and
this.
It was very secretive.
So what about the – was there a male-to-female ratio as to who was spanking and who was getting spanked? I mean, I'm just wondering if
– Oh, it was pretty well even.
Okay.
Yeah.
And would people sort of switch their roles as well? Would people switch up?
All right, my turn.
They were mostly one or the other.
Aha, uh-huh. Okay. Got it.
Yeah, I mean, there were people who specialized in being dominant and – people who were not interested in being dominant at all.
Was there interesting clothing?
In clothing?
Yeah.
Not really.
Okay.
I mean,
nobody's wearing a patent leather bodysuit with a mask with a zipper across the mouth, right?
Well, there wasn't the mask, but the bodysuits were there.
Okay.
I mean, you know, and if you were going to engage in sexual intercourse, you were going to go in the other room. And do it not in front of everyone. It wasn't
right.
An orgy.
That's interesting. Okay, so there were acts of dominance and submission happening in sort of the general room, but no actual sexual penetration happening there.
Right.
Interesting.
And it was a big room. It was a nice place actually.
Cool.
And I would say the people who were involved were some of them were professionals. I think a couple of them are lawyers now.
Like a professional, by professional you meant their job type, that they're professional dominatrix.
Yeah.
Gotcha.
And the whole thing was, you know, you keep this to yourself. You don't go out and start talking to people about this because even in a city as big as Madison, which
people
isn't
talk,
that big,
yeah.
about 200,000 people, people talk.
The first
and
rule of spanking club is there's no talking
thing.
About spanking club.
Right. Because if you admit to someone you do that, they judge you automatically.
Yeah, I would think they really do.
Yeah.
Well, I can't see how I would choose in my life. I cannot see how I would not make some kind of like assumptions and, you know, get some kind of sort of feelings of superiority and those kind of things. And I, you know, like that's probably something for me to work on, but I can totally see people are going to be judging you.
I mean, and there were people there that were also involved in the polyamory lifestyle, but that wasn't like there wasn't anything you weren't required to get involved. If you could watch if you wanted to, you didn't have to take off your clothes. It was safety was the number one thing in that environment.
So it's fascinating. I'm really glad you called in about this. I know you're not supposed to talk about it, but I think it's been
well, you know, I listen to you guys as often as I can, and sometimes I'm compelled to call in. And this time I'm like, well, there's really no one calling in who's explaining how you could get into this or what it's like.
Have you read the 50 Shades of Grey? Did you already answer that?
I haven't. It's on my Kindle. Okay. Because it was free one weekend, and I tend to grab up free books.
Sure.
And I just haven't been able to, you know, I've heard George Takei read bits of it and Gilbert Gottfried, but beyond that,
do you care to speculate on why there is such fascination for this, like sort of this latent fascination?
Probably for the same reason my mother, like, bought grocery bags full of romance novels. Like, it's either something you're not getting in your relationship, or it's taboo and exciting, or it could just be innate. Like, it might just be some primal thing where, you know, missionary just doesn't really do it for people as much as they like to think it does.
Tom, good call. Thanks for making it tonight. Yeah. Really informative. I appreciate the personal story.
One more thing, Tom, before...
Oh, sorry.
Did you drop him? Oh, well, yeah, I wasn't sure. I just wanted to know whether Tom had been spanked or not. No, I meant real, like as a child.
Oh, as a child. Okay, gotcha. Let's go to Harold in Watertown. You're on Free Talk Live. Hello, Harold. Although he didn't seek that out, Mark.
Hello, how are you?
No, it just sort of came to him. Hey, Harold, we're good. Go ahead with your thoughts.
My thoughts on 50 Shades of Grey, I have to say that some people are into strange stuff.
Yep.
You know?
Well, but now, why is it strange?
I've got another question. If enough people are into strange stuff, is it strange anymore?
I mean, this is a very, very popular thing, apparently, to be into, at the very least, to you know, watch and to consider and think about. What makes it strange?
Because, in my opinion, spanking is supposed to be for discipline only, and not an act of love or compassion, you know?
Well, here's this is like the greater category of kink. If more than 50% of the population is into kink, is it still strange?
Hold that thought, Harold. We can bring you back to continue the discussion. BDSM, 50 Shades of Grey, it's hitting the theaters this weekend, and lots of people are watching it. What's the fascination? 855-450-FREE, Free Talk Live.
Get to Lumber Liquidators Spring Flooring Kickoff Sale and save on all the latest hardwood flooring trends. Get the hot new look of gray flooring plus 80 more styles of laminate from 49 cents. Check out gorgeous matte finished hardwood from Bellawood or choose from more than 200 styles of pre-finished hardwood from 169. Plus deals on distressed floors and over 70 styles of bamboo from 179. And get 18-month special financing for deals on over 400 floors. Get to the Spring Flooring Kickoff Sale. Visit LumberLiquidators.com to find a store near you.
Gabino lives in Palcapata, Peru. He buys old appliances like irons, radios, and TV sets, fixes them up, and resells them. He saw an opportunity to expand his business and needed a loan to buy more appliances. Free Talk Live helped him get a loan, and the expansion was a success. You can help us help more people by getting your coffee through coffee.freetalklive.com. Make a difference, one cup at a time. Get a free pound to try out the subscription. Cancel anytime. coffee.freetalklive.com.
If you want to move to the free state and you're looking for some real estate, well, I know a guy who's really great. It's the realtor Mark Warden. Do you want a home with 20 acres, a lakeside cabin, any takers for renters, buyers, and sellers too? Mark Warden is the guy for you. PorcupineRealEstate.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number two is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Saturday, February 14th, 2015. Silver is trading at $17.36 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,230 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $245. Antiwar.com reports Pentagon officials claimed on Friday that the Islamic State attempted to attack an Ayn al-Assad airbase where U.S. ground troops were stationed but failed before they got too close to the U.S. troops. Details are scant, but the Pentagon narrative is that an unknown number of the Islamic State forces who were part of the group that took the town of Baghdadi got into a battle with Iraqi ground troops who managed to repel them. It is unclear whether the Islamic State forces made a serious move towards the base or were simply reconnoitering after taking Baghdadi, a town just 5 miles away from the base. The reports are intended to ease concerns that U.S. troops who were positioned at the front line base are going to quickly find themselves in combat roles, but even if the initial move was repelled, the Islamic State has shown remarkable stubbornness in offensives against important bases, and Ayn al-Assad is probably going to be in their sights for some time. For over 35 years, Robertson Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Robertson Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co. Reuters reports a law enforcement officer shot and wounded an inmate Friday evening during a confrontation in the restroom in the Dallas-Fort Worth International Airport, according to airport officials. Airport spokesman David McGonagh said no flight schedules had been affected by the shooting inside the bathroom near Gate C-10, where the security checkpoint will be closed until Saturday night. The shooting took place around 5 p.m. local time and involved one of two officers from the Tulsa County Sheriff's Department in Oklahoma who were escorting a prisoner through the airport. The officer fired his weapon twice during the scuffle and the inmate was shot once in the hand. McGonagh said the suspect then fled the restroom and ran from the departure area of the terminal to the public side, a distance of about 100 feet before being apprehended by the Tulsa County officers near the C-10 checkpoint. Both the inmate and officer were transported to Parkland Hospital in Dallas by ambulance. No other injuries were reported. No information was released about any injuries to the officer or the condition of either man. Several arriving flights were rerouted to other gates, but departing flights were not affected. You can support FPP Radio by joining the Fans program. Fans are friends, allies, and numerary supporters. Fans help FPP afford to produce more original content. You can join the Fans program for as little as $3 per month or any amount of Bitcoin per month, thanks to the recurring payment options provided by Coinbase. To learn more or to join the Fans program, visit fans.fppradio.com. That's fans.fppradio.com. UPI reports Oregon Governor John Kitzhaber announced his resignation Friday amid allegations he and his fiancée used his position to get her private consulting work and a role as an unpaid advisor. The Democratic governor broke the news to his staff Friday just weeks after he was sworn in as the state's first four-term governor. The effective date of his resignation is unclear. Kitzhaber has come under fire after media reports that his fiancée, Sylvia Hayes, received $118,000 in consulting fees in 2011 and 2012 from the Washington, D.C.-based Clean Economy Development Center while advising the governor about tax issues. Kitzhaber did not disclose her income from the group on his annual economic interest statements. Hayes also admitted that in 1997, she married an Ethiopian immigrant in exchange for $5,000 and she purchased land with a former boyfriend to grow marijuana. The Oregonian, the largest newspaper in the state, called for Kitzhaber to resign. Before doing so, the newspaper's editorial board had supported Kitzhaber in his four gubernatorial elections. Under Oregon law, Secretary of State Kate Brown would replace Kitzhaber upon resignation. He abruptly summoned her back from a conference she was attending in Washington, D.C. earlier this week. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
This is the Onion Week in Review. A report by Stanford University researchers released Thursday found that Americans spend 90% of their waking hours staring at glowing rectangles. Researchers identified more than 30 varieties of iridescent rectangles, ranging from personal and work rectangles to rectangles that heat food and those that can fit right in one's pocket.
From the moment Americans wake up, they are captivated by these bright, pulsing rectangles. In fact, if you look at the data, it's hard to find a single minute when the public isn't captivated by these, excuse me. I'm sorry, where were we?
In local news, a runover squirrel is remembered as frantic and indecisive. And in other news, a trail of rose petals leads a wife to a sink full of dishes. Prince Fielder reports to spring training exactly the right amount overweight, and a local yard sale reeks of divorce. If you don't hear the sound of my voice the same time next week, alert my family and then visit theonion.com/newsbeat.
This is Free Talk Live. Welcome to the program. If you're just tuning in, our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And of course, you can bring up anything you want. I'm sure there are a variety of things that happened this week that you might want to share with us here, your opinions on them. You're certainly welcome to do that. The bulk of the first hour, however, was taken up by discussion about 50 Shades of Grey, and more so about the reason why it's so popular, because honestly, I've never read it, and I have not seen the movie, and Mark, neither have you.
No.
So, you know, we're coming from a...
I shan't be spending money on for a theater ticket for it, either.
Nor will I. So, not so much about the details of the book itself or what happens in the book, but more about why it's so popular. Why is it that 50 Shades of Grey is this phenomenon and has been now for a couple of years, it seems like? I mean, I remember hearing the original reports about this book when it was blowing up a while back, and now you've got the movie that's taking box offices by storm. It's setting a record for the Valentine's Day weekend. I don't know if they're adjusting for inflation with that record setting, but nonetheless, it's doing quite well with $30 million taken in on the first day, which was yesterday. And so why is this thing such a phenomenon? Why are people so interested in it? Did this book or this movie facilitate people getting into BDSM, or is it something that has just sparked the flames of interest more publicly, that this has always been, that people have always been interested in BDSM, but now there's more of a conversation surrounding it? Now something that has been kept sort of in the darkness and not discussed is now more likely to be discussed at a water cooler or a dinner table or something like that because of this book. So I think there's some interesting issues surrounding this, and would love to get to your calls and thoughts here, and that's where we're going to go right now. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. What's your experience and thoughts? Please share. Let's go to Bob, listening in Atlanta, Georgia, to LRN.FM. Hello, Bob.
Hello. I just wanted to take it from a few different perspectives here. I've been doing it for 9 years. I was 18 with my first girlfriend.
Okay.
Currently, I'm 27 years old. And basically, from an anatomy and physiology perspective, it just works. Okay, the human body, you can manipulate it so that it can create orgasms more so than most other things. Climax a lot better. Like, I've literally taken a whip, used it on a woman, and she has climaxed multiple times as a result.
So when you say it works, what you're saying is it, for you, makes sex more pleasurable than it would be on average.
No. What I'm saying is not just for me, but I'm saying overall, it's like when you take something as basic as, when you take something as basic as, slow versus rough or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
Generally speaking, every single woman I have been with 71, they all have climaxed more quickly from the rough. Eventually, you might start slow, but then eventually it goes rougher and rougher, and then they climax a lot harder and more times that way. So it's just, that's just a matter of, you know, friction, and that's just a matter of, you know, repeatedly stimulating a certain part that will send that climaxing message.
But when, I mean, but from when, at what point does it cross from, going hard to actually pulling out a riding crop or a whip or something like that?
It's just all these things, these are all, everything is a nerve. You know, all these things that we're doing, it's all affecting nerves in different ways. And sometimes, you know, how one whip might affect someone differently. Like, I have been whipped and I don't like it personally.
Okay.
But I also, you know, but as a woman who, you know, in a society where she grew up in a certain way, and then so mentally she feels that deep down she's always wanted to be dominated and stuff like that. So just, it starts off, yes, appealing to me from a mental perspective. I want to be dominated. And then physically, you slowly go through it. You slowly acclimatize yourself to being dominated, as the person being dominated, like Anastasia Steele in this case. And then you experience new things at a certain level. It's kind of like working out. The more, your body can only take so much at first. And then, you know, 6 months later, you're basically running marathons or doing the equivalent of that. And you can take a whole lot and you get the equivalent of that runner's high. It's the same concept. When you work out.
So there's adrenaline. That was what a previous caller had mentioned, that there's an adrenaline rush involved in this.
It's hormonal. It's, you know, it's psychological. It's just standard physiology.
Now, you said you started at 18 with your first girlfriend at that time. Was it she that kind of brought you into it? How did that happen?
It was kind of both. Mm-hmm. I'd always wanted to do that before, but she was just my first girlfriend.
You'd always wanted to. What? Now, why always?
For a long time.
When did you realize that?
I have no idea. Just, you know, I see, you know, a very beautiful girl, and I naturally want to be aggressive. Not, that's a loaded word. I want to be dominant with her in a consensual, in the bedroom format. Hmm. Or, you know, where you discuss, then you discuss some more, and then you act on it slowly, and then you acclimatize you and your partner to however you want to do it. And basically, the more advanced it gets, the more pleasure your partner comes from it. The more pleasure comes from it for your partner. So, for example, am I actually in a situation, who do you think was in charge? Anastasia Steele, the female, or Christian Grey, the male?
These are the characters, just to clarify, these are the characters in 50 Shades of Grey. I couldn't answer you because I haven't seen the movie or read the book.
So. I know who's getting the attention, right? Like, Anastasia's in the focus of attention. And so I would say that from a psychological standpoint, a masochist is somebody who's, you know, to some extent self-absorbed.
Well, no, not necessarily. I'm saying, who is the dominant one? You might think that Christian Grey is the dominant one, but he is, in fact, not the one. Because he has to listen to her ultimate boundaries. He can't, for example, cut her hand off because he might feel that that's sexy or something like that. You know, I'm going extremes to illustrate a point here. So because she says, no, you can't do that, guess what? Christian Grey can't do that. If he does, he's going to go to jail for a long time. So what I'm saying is, let's just clear up everything right now for all you listeners out there that are kind of wondering, I might be into S&M, I'm not sure. If you are submissive, if you are the one who is receiving the actions, you have the ultimate right to say no. You have the right to set the limits. You set the limits, and then your partner is just the workhorse, the dominant guy or dominant woman is the workhorse who gets you to your pleasure, and then as a result, he gets his pleasure. So when I'm with my partner, I'll go sometimes for 2 hours, just continuously sweating profusely, getting, you know what I'm saying, like just working and working and working to make her climax and pleasure, be pleasured. You know, yeah, she might have a couple of welts on her butt or something like that, but guess what? She wants it. She asked for it. She specifically says, I want to be whipped.
So are you saying that the person who is the submissive in the classic dominant submissive position, if you will, that person you're arguing is actually the dominant one because they're the ones who are saying when?
Yes. From the ultimate perspective, in fantasy, I'm the dominant one.
Yeah.
In fantasy, but she's letting me have that fit.
Interesting.
You know, she's bestowing that honor upon me, so to speak. She's saying, all right, I'm giving you my body. You can use it how you wish, and I'm going to orgasm as a result because I know these things I like, these things I might like, these things you're not going to do because I don't trust you enough.
Okay.
And if you do these things, then that's potentially sexual assault, and our relationship is over, and you're probably going to go to jail for a long time.
Bob, were you spanked as a child?
Was I spanked as a child?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Do you think that had anything to do with it?
No.
Okay. Where do you think it comes from?
Because I know just a general desire to, I've always been that way.
You're born with it. You're saying you were born with it.
It's kind of like being gay.
Interesting. Thanks for sharing.
You can learn new things about yourself, but I think you're born with it.
Yeah, some things you always know. Interesting call, Bob. I really appreciate the personal story and thoughts and observations. Thank you. I feel like I've learned some stuff here so far tonight, and we're only into our second hour. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Still to come tonight, other stuff, including a young boy of middle school, I guess, right, who threw a flag out of a window at school, and the FBI was called.
That's
Mark,
correct.
You have that story. We can talk about it. But, of course, if you want to share with us your thoughts on the 50 Shades of Grey, the BDSM lifestyle, what is it that is attractive to you about it? Why is this so popular now? 855-450-FREE.
Here's a special message for those of you who owe the IRS at least $10,000 or more in back taxes. The IRS has special programs in place that could eliminate or reduce your tax debt by thousands of dollars. Call the tax helpline that has been set up to help you. 800-691-6129. That's 800-691-6129. Stop the wage garnishments, levies, and tax liens now. Once you've qualified and enrolled, the IRS will stop all the collection activities against you. These unique programs have been allocated to help the economy and significantly reduce or eliminate your tax burden. The IRS is currently accepting reduced settlements and other favorable programs. You may qualify for substantial savings, so get the help you need. For free information and to see if you qualify, take down the number now for the Tax Representation Hotline. 800-691-6129. That's 800-691-6129. 800-691-6129.
Again, the Congressional Budget Office sounds the alarm. This time warns of Greek-style U.S. debt crises. You heard me right. The GAO is drawing a parallel between the U.S. economy, its debt, and the current Greek economic meltdown. With the debt-to-GDP chart climbing into unfamiliar territory, the growing budget deficit will rise to unsupportable levels. Hi, this is Ted Anderson. The Federal Debt and Risk of Financial Crises document the CBO has published is a must-read for every American. Covering the risk of continued deficit spending coupled with an aging population and the rising interest rates spell economic disaster. It's imperative that you get a copy of this document and study it for yourself. Call me today at 800-686-2237, and I'll send you a free copy. Again, call 800-686-2237 and ask for your copy of the CBO document. Once again, you need to read this government report. Call 800-686-2237.
A meme is not easy to define.
What is it?
But you know it when you see it.
Amazing.
Don'tTreadOnMeme.com proves that.
I feel so enlightened.
Don't Tread on Meme, M-E-M-E, helping you give the finger to our monetary system of deception by providing you with silver dime trading cards. Unlike today's dollar, they have value, and they look neat too.
Oh, would you look at those? Aren't those just swell?
Don'tTreadOnMeme.com. While you're browsing their numerous silver dime card designs, take time to download the easy-to-use Silver Calculator app. This simple piece of technology lets you know instantly, whether using iPhone or Android, just how much your silver coin is worth. Find out all the details at Don'tTreadOnMeme.com. Now accepting Bitcoin. Don't Tread on Meme, your path to a voluntary society with honest money. Don'tTreadOnMeme.com, serving you faster than the Fed prints money.
If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com. Thanks to Bitcoin, LRN.FM is able to provide our free-to-air satellite channel across North and Central America. You can listen to LRN.FM 24/7 via satellite for no monthly cost. Learn more about our satellite channel at sat.lrn.fm. And if you'd like to help us continue to expand, you can send us Bitcoins via the address you'll find under the Bitcoin graphic in the right column of LRN.FM. To learn more about Bitcoin, visit weusecoins.com. That's weusecoins.com.
You can connect with the Liberty Radio Network via our Facebook page at facebook.lrn.fm. That's facebook.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. You can dial in toll-free to bring up anything you want here on the live Saturday edition of the program. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Joining you tonight in studio, Ian here.
And Mark.
And you can hook up with some of your favorite cryptocurrencies with ExpressCoin.
Right. I mean, you know, Bitcoin, a lot of people are expecting it to go upwards. I am expecting it to go up in value. I'm thinking that now might be a good time to buy some Bitcoins. They're on sale. So, you know, by that I mean that the price is lower than I believe that they are worth. I don't mean that ExpressCoin is selling them on sale, because why would they? You know, it's a currency. It's worth what it's worth. You can go there and get Bitcoins, Litecoin, Dogecoins, fast, safe, easy, inexpensive. Their fees aren't much at all. I'd say they're the lowest fees among sort of the major places to get Bitcoins. They're a licensed money services business. You can get all your cryptocurrencies with a money order or a check. Just go to expresscoin.com. Whether you're in the U.S. or Canada, it's cool. You can even do it from your smartphone, because they've got an app over at expresscoin.com to make it easy for you. If you use coupon code FTL, that's FTL as in Free Talk Live. If you like Free Talk Live. If you don't like Free Talk Live, then it's FTL as in faster than light. That's fine, too. use coupon code FTL and get up to $40 worth of your cryptocurrency at no fee at all. It's expresscoin.com, and you can get, you know, pay nothing if you get less than $40 worth at expresscoin.com by using coupon code FTL. That's meant for people who are just sort of trying it out. You may want to invest more, in which case, you know, you'll be paying their fees and, you know, making so they can stay in business. Expresscoin.com.
Fees are very, very reasonable.
Yeah, expresscoin.com.
All right. So our toll free number again is 855-450-FREE. We also have Skype. You can Skype in at username lrn.fm. I have not read 50 Shades of Grey. I'm not particularly interested in reading 50 Shades of Grey. The movie is out this weekend, and it is taking box offices by storm. The book itself was very, very popular. Lots of people were talking about it. Lots of people were secretly reading it and didn't want to talk about it.
Yep.
And I'm just wondering why. What's the fascination? We did have a guy call in a moment ago saying that he believed he was born interested in BDSM, that it wasn't something that was learned behavior. And Mark, you had suggested that maybe parents spanking their kids perhaps could lead to an interest.
It's something I've read. It's not me just, you know, wildly speculating.
Yeah.
You had speculated that it had something to do with the Puritan nature of sort of sexuality in the United States.
Sadism, masochism, bondage, and discipline. Let's go to Dan. Would love to get your thoughts on why 50 Shades of Grey is such a phenomenon, and or your comments on BDSM in that that kind of world in general. Dan, you're on Free Talk Live.
Yeah, I think that it may be only the behavior may only be as healthy as the society you live in. Because, I don't know, like Pompeii, people weren't that healthy because of the degradation of the society from the top down. But where we live in America here, I don't think people are that healthy because the economy and stuff like that, and people may lack meaning or purpose in their life. So that will give you a short term meaning and purpose, something like that. And then like any drug, it makes you go to more of an extreme, especially if you're using it for a drug, which like I said, if the society isn't that healthy, then you're going to have unhealthy people getting into this stuff, and then they have.
So there's a lot kind of in there in what you've just said. There's a lot to really, I think, dig into here, and I want to do that. So you're suggesting that this is an unhealthy thing to do, and that people who, you know, they're looking for something to do with their time or whatever. You suggested,
I guess, that's what life on planet Earth's about, looking for something to do.
I mean, many of the people who are involved in these things are very, very successful. I mean, they're obviously mentally healthy enough to where they've been able to create successful businesses. Are you saying that this isn't physical health you're talking about? You're talking about mental health, right?
Yeah, well, I'm talking about societal health, you know what I mean? But you said something about people that are successful, and I don't know. I'm worried about the word successful because I come from sort of royalty a little bit, and my grandmother is super powerful and stuff. And those people, you know, if you're around them, they're really unhealthy. They need like
boats, yachts, and weird behavior, because when a human being gets to a level where they're more, people treat them like gods, because then you have a lot of money, like the people treat you like God, they are have difficult times being content in life. That's why they need all the big toys, all the weird behavior, this and that. So I don't know how successful they are. That's almost a drug in itself, where you can't get off the wagon of the money game, where you're just addicted to it. And you just get turned on. Pretty soon you're turned on by controlling people and stuff, because they'll treat you like a god. And once you go down that road and start thinking that way, which powerful business people, I just came from the Cayman Islands, where I went to parties with people in that venue. You know, and them people, they're fun to party with, but they're out there, and they take a lot to be content, and they're unhealthy. Like it says in Pompeii, it probably trickled down from the top down, so the elite people wouldn't feel like there's anything wrong with them, because our whole society is like that now.
Yeah, I can see to some extent where you're coming from. I have no clue what went on in Pompeii, although I've been there one time. Most folks had evacuated there about the time of Vesuvius's eruption. But I guess I do see how successful people, very successful people, people maybe not even successful, people that just have everything that they want, that can... It would cause,
doesn't make them happy.
Yeah,
right?
It would cause just sort of different behavior than what I'm used to. I'm busy trying to pay bills and things like that. You know, like I'd like my farm to function a little better, and that would take some money and get some equipment and those kind of things. So I think those are sort of normal thought processes.
But is it too simple? Is it oversimplifying to say, oh well, this is society's fault. Society is has degraded over time, and so therefore that's why these things are so popular. That seems like it's, maybe a too easy of an answer. I mean, we did actually have a guy say that he feels like he was born this way. He has, for his entire life, always wanted to be dominant towards a woman by consent. But nonetheless,
he'll probably be okay if he's healthy. He'll probably be okay. But I'm just talking in generality that the society, because of the economy and this and that, and then Americans, they have to have immediate gratification because they're brainwashed by the mainstream media. And they want, a lot of the spirituality stuff has a lot to do with it. You know what I mean? About people don't have a rudder to sort of guide them through life, and they're being guided by the mainstream media and all this, trying to get some satisfaction, out of material things and stuff. Yeah, you're gonna go down the wrong path. Like he'll probably do fine if he's healthy. But I'm just, like I said, I'm talking in generalities and in general. So another thing too is that I never knew it was that difficult to try and, achieve some sort of sexual pleasure. I mean, this is a hell of a lot of effort just to get some pleasure, guys.
Thanks for the call tonight, Dan. I appreciate hearing from you. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Maybe he was referring to the guy who said he had to work for 2 hours on his girlfriend before she would come to a very heavy orgasm.
Well,
it seems like a long time to invest, but
right,
some people are into that.
Right. Well, I would definitely say that, from where I stand, that is too much time invested in, sex or whatever. That's your business, and that's the way, you want things. That's cool, but, I guess I got other things that I want to accomplish, too.
The toll-free number tonight is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. I don't personally think this is an indictment on society being unhealthy or anything like that. And I think it is healthy for people to talk about sex and to talk about the things that they're interested in, to get these things out in the open. It's one of the reasons why I'm really enjoying the new show on LRN.FM called Flaming Freedom. There's more coming up on Free Talk Live.
This is Tim Austin, Senior Vice President of Kmart. Our company is working together with the March of Dimes through March for Babies to raise money and awareness about the serious problem of premature birth in the U.S. As a business leader, I know that babies born very sick or too soon cost businesses billions of dollars each year. That's why Kmart is committed to raising funds through our employees, customers, family, and friends to improve the health of moms and babies everywhere. Won't you please join us in March for Babies? Start a team today at marchforbabies.org.
We've been patiently waiting. Waiting while you tried to ignore us. Waiting while you acted like we didn't exist. Waiting for our chance to be taken seriously. The wait is over. GCN is available 24/7 at GCNlive.com. Navigate through news from your favorite hosts and download archives of past shows. Download the app on your smartphone Counter tab or visit GCNLive.com for instant access and live streaming. GCNLive.com, the future of talk radio, now at your fingertips.
Why did you move to the Shire?
I moved here to the Shire because there's other people around who take liberty just as seriously as I do.
I moved to the Shire because I saw videos of people challenging authority and thought that I could get support myself. It called to me, like, do this right now.
I wanted to be around people like me who got it. And once I got here, I knew there was nowhere else that I wanted to be.
I've always wanted to change the world. So I moved to the Shire to join people who were actually working towards doing the same thing.
The people here are awesome, loving, and positive. It was for the adventure and for the feeling of something important is happening here. And I just wanted to come to sort of be part of that.
Visit ShireSociety.com to read and sign the Shire Society Declaration and learn the reasons why, if you love liberty, you should immigrate to the Shire. Plus, add yourself to the Shire map at ShireSociety.com. That's ShireSociety.com.
Liberty activists around the country are starting to realize politics alone won't set us free. So what will? At Liberty on the Rocks, we believe the answer starts with living your principles, spreading ideas, and connecting with those around you. By starting a Liberty on the Rocks network, you can make a difference by uniting libertarian thinkers. Find out how much fun it is to build your local network from the ground up. Visit libertyontherocks.org today to get started.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's post pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing, to be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. Physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with a chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. You are invited to join us toll-free here on the air at 855-450-FREE. You can bring up anything you want. Coming up, we get the chance. Mark, you have a story about a middle school young man who has gotten in some hot water for throwing the American flag out of a school window. Apparently, the FBI were even called into that particular case. Mark will share that with us if we get the chance, but your calls come first here. You can dial in toll-free and bring up anything you'd like. We have been talking about 50 Shades of Grey and specifically why it's such a phenomenon. Why is it that this movie has, and the book, that the book series, I guess a trilogy that preceded it, why have they been so popular? What is it about it that has it tapped into inside Americans that has really worked? And the toll-free number here is 855-450-FREE. It's led to a larger conversation about the BDSM lifestyle and how people, you know, start down the road to getting into that. Of course, people have been calling in to sort of pass judgment on that. Some have suggested that there's something dirty about it, or that it suggests that something's wrong with society. And our toll-free number here, you're welcome to share your thoughts, is 855-450-FREE. We've got Skype as well. It's Skype username lrn.fm. Nick is on the line listening in Charleston, South Carolina. Hello, Nick.
Hey, I read about a fourth of the book.
Okay.
And it seems like the appeal is that the main character, Christian Grey, is so very rich. I mean, the author took great pains to describe how rich and opulent his house was and the expensive clothes that he bought for the girl.
Why would that be the appeal? Are you suggesting that the people reading the book would like to be wined and dined by this person?
Exactly.
It's not so much the fact that there's BDSM going on. It's just that there's some rich guy. I mean, Batman's got a rich guy in it, too. I mean, is that really turning women on? Not so much, right? Like, it can't just be that there's a rich character in the book.
Well, to the young girl who is the object of all of his attentions, she's a college girl. And I don't know, it seems like if I were that girl, although I'm a guy, it would be very appealing to have a friend with that amount of money and wealth and opulence and everything else. Because there was a comparison to, you know, her other friends that were just doing okay in college, guy-wise, having normal dating guy relationships and stuff, and she is all of a sudden, basically, it's a Cinderella story.
Yeah, I can see it. I don't, in the same way that I think that it's a cheap storytelling mechanism to sort of call people princes and princesses. It is a way to make significant in very few words the character. Oh, well, she's important. She's a princess. Rather than sort of, you know, making that person important in other ways. I think that there's way too much emphasis on, wealth, especially wealth, when it comes to men.
But there's a zillion stories out there with some girl being...
That doesn't make it okay.
What? No, what I was saying was there's a zillion stories out there that have characters who are wealthy.
Sure.
And
they're more interesting.
But my point is, why is this one the one that has taken off? I mean, you're saying that BDSM has nothing to do with it? I mean, that seems to be the real focus of this story. Although there is a good question that I think should be asked, and I forget where I saw this originally, but the question was, would this book have been as big a seller if the man was homeless? I mean, if...
Exactly. I mean, lesser men would be charged with criminal domestic violence.
Well, perhaps. I mean, not if it's we just had a guy call in who dole out spankings to any gal who asks nicely. Apparently
right,
he hasn't been arrested.
If you don't have the money to back up the spanking, then she's going to charge you.
I don't know I think that's just wild speculation.
Yeah, thanks for the call, Nick. I appreciate hearing from you. Let's talk to Abel. He's on the line in New Hampshire via Skype. Hello, Abel.
Howdy.
Hey, you're on the air.
I'm back again. Now, listen, Mark, I have to say, you kind of diverted the conversation from, puritanicalism to, corporal punishment. And I think those two are very, very kind of connected from a historical point of view.
What do you mean?
That the Puritans were strong believers in corporal punishments. You know, spare the rod and spare the child. Or
spoil the child.
Spoil the child,
yeah.
Whatever.
Which means that if you're spanking your kid with a hand, that you don't love them.
We also know that the Puritans were very much resistant to the free expression of things sexual.
Sure.
Is that, a false statement? So here you are with, suppressing sex, spanking your children, and then launching them into the wonderful world of hormones and somewhere in their adolescence and onto adulthood, without really any kind of nurturing attitude about sexual relationships. And so you start out with this, idea that sex is bad, spanking is good. And here you are with discipline. That's the discipline part of the bondage would be your tied up.
Mm-hmm.
Discipline is your punishing for whatever reason. sadomasochism is where you have a sadist and a masochist.
A sadist being someone who likes to deliver punishment, and the masochist being someone who likes to receive.
Right. And I think these are all kind of, you know, and I think it's wonderful that there's actually an outlet for people to do that, because, you know, they're all saddled with these things. And I, you know, personally, I have no interest. I mean, I want to, you know, when I love someone and I want to express intimacy, I want to do that as a healthy human being.
So would you call it unhealthy if somebody chooses to do otherwise?
I think as long as you keep it in control and don't, you know, damage each other, and you want to do that, I mean, it's okay. But I think that there's some part of it that interferes with maybe the best relationship you may want.
See, I don't want to pass judgment. That's one thing I don't want to do here. Is I don't feel like it's not un. I don't feel like the way I have had intimacy with people is necessarily the right way, or that other people should try to emulate that. I think everybody's got their own thing, and as long as it's done consensually, I think that's what's healthy, is to do things consensually. Everybody's got different interests.
I agree with that. However, I guess my default position is I pass judgment, and then I believe that I am open to hearing evidence to the contrary to my position, but because what I prefer seems normal and healthy to me, I tend to think that this is therefore not that. So,
well, that's just you acting like you're superior and that you've got the right way or whatever.
I guess it is.
I don't think there's any right or wrong way to do sex. Well, I'm sorry, take that back. Consensually, I don't think there's any, you know, wrong way to do things. Obviously, the wrong way to do sex is to not have consent by the other partner. But beyond that, as far as I'm concerned, it's all healthy, although it might seem unusual from our perspective. You know, we can't relate to it. I can't understand why bringing physical pain to someone is pleasurable, but for some people, apparently, it is. And so I'm not going to say that that's one way is a good way and one way is a bad way. Thanks for the call tonight, Abel. Can I go ahead?
Add one a little bit. The fact is that if it springs from a suppression of things sexual
and then that's a big question. I thank you for the call tonight. And I don't know. And we did have the guy earlier who said that he's always felt this way. So that's an argument saying that it might have been by birth. 855-450-FREE.
I have two cats and two dogs. All four of them are on the Dynavite. This stuff is amazing. The first day that I gave Sweet Pea and Daisy the Dynavite for cats, in fact, I did add a little bit of the Lick-A Chops, and they absolutely loved it. All the vitamins, the minerals, you know, they also enjoyed the num-nums, the nub-nubs or whatever they're called, the treats that also came along with it.
DINOVITE.com.
859-428-1000.
They're just running through the house. They're playing. My Sweet Pea will walk in front of me. She'll stop where she's at, drop and roll onto her back, and then expect me to rub her belly. Just like a kitten. Daisy and Sookie have a cat tree in my living room, and lately she's been climbing up to the top, jumping up there, and then she'll climb back down, and then she's right back up again. Oh, I'm sorry. I wish they would make a product for us humans to give us the same amount of energy and gunk that Dynavite for cats are given for my cats. The phone number is 859-428-1000.
859-428-1000.
DINOVITE.com.
Are you hungry for delicious, nutritious, rich, and satisfying home-cooked meals? Discover the Vita Clay 4-in-1 Smart Organic Cooker. Unglazed Zeesha Clay, an ancient secret that makes this fast multi-cooker so special. Infusing your food with incredible flavors, perfect texture, vitamins, and minerals for your good health. It's a slow cooker, rice cooker, a steamer, plus a yogurt maker. Go to VitaClayChef.com and enter promo code RADIO20 for 20% off at checkout. That's VitaClayChef.com.
It's no secret that government and big business buy in bulk and get huge discounts. Not available to the little guy.
Until now. Introducing a breakthrough crowd buying website where people can join together, buy in bulk, and get massive discounts on millions of popular products. It's togethersave.com. Togethersave.com. You can save 20, 30, or even 50% off tablets, smartphones, cars, appliances, textbooks, sports equipment, video games, and much more. All with free delivery. Check it out. Togethersave.com. Visit now and start group buying today at togethersave.com.
If you're David, a few well-chosen words can help level the playing field with Goliath. I'm Holland Cook from SurvivalSpeech.com. Recently, I saw a Yellow Pages ad for an appliance repair company, and the headline read, "Why wait for Sears?" If you're going to the Yellow Pages, the Dead Sea Scrolls of advertising, you're ready to buy right now. So this is an attention-grabbing message. And how about the plumber whose radio ad says, "Call by noon Thursday, and we'll be there Saturday at no extra cost." Smart guy. Most plumbing firms give their crew the weekend off. This one gives them Sunday and Monday off. In the words of a respected advertising executive, "Cut to the chase, make it quick, and tell me exactly what you can do for me, especially if you're looking for work." For more tips on critical communication skills for the way things are now, hit SurvivalSpeech.com. I'm Holland Cook.
So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet, around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm.
Shiny badges on your jacket, shiny badges.
This is Davi Barker from shinybadges.com, and I just want to personally apologize for airing a jingle week after week, month after month, that turned out to be such an infectious brain worm. So to make it up to you, I'm offering a free gift. The next time you make a purchase at shinybadges.com, write "worms" in the transaction comments, and I'll send you something weird.
Help get LRN.fm into more ears. Visit promote.lrn.fm for a free bumper sticker, flyers, banners, graphics, and more. Promote.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live, and you can dial in toll-free to share your thoughts with us about BDSM, 50 Shades of Grey. Why is this book and now this movie or these series of books... why so popular? What is it that it's tapping into in people in America that maybe they didn't realize existed, or maybe they did realize existed, but have always kept quiet about? And now a conversation's happening, and that's what we've been discussing throughout most of the show tonight. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. And Mark and I, we are coming from a position of relative ignorance on this. We have not read the books. We have not seen the movie, but maybe you have, and or maybe you haven't and you want to speculate. Either way, it's up to you. You can share your thoughts. Maybe you've been in the BDSM scene and you want to share some experiences. We've had that happen so far here tonight. Some people have called to pass judgment and share their opinions about this. So anything goes here. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We have Skype as well. You can Skype in at username lrn.fm. Also coming up, the Texas Bitcoin Conference. It's not quite right around the corner, but it's going to be here before you know it. March 28th and 29th. That's what, about 6 weeks from now?
Yeah, sounds right.
So we're going to be there, by the way, Mark. You and I, we're going down
to be a blast.
Austin, Texas for the second year of this great conference, which was good last year and is going to be even better this year, because this time it's going to be happening in downtown Austin in the Moody Theater, and there's going to be great speakers as always. George Gilder is going to be there. He is a world-famous investor, economist, and author. He'll be keynoting the event. IBM's architect of their blockchain technology, Sambala Nair, will be flying in from India. Other speakers, including Vitalik Buterin, Robert Murphy, Jason King, and David Johnston. Many speakers are still being lined up. You can get the latest listing over at TexasBitcoinConference.com. And this is a big event. I mean, if you are interested in Bitcoin,
Maybe you are an expert. Maybe you're totally new into Bitcoin. This is the place to go. This is where the people who are the movers and the shakers in the Bitcoin universe are going to be. TexasBitcoinConference.com also hosts the second $1 million Bitcoin 2.0 hackathon, which is pretty fascinating stuff. We actually had some of the folks on from that hackathon last year to tell us about some of the neat stuff they came up with. And there were some really innovative ideas come up with where these guys, these programmers, are just cranking out programming for like, what, 24 hours or something ridiculous like
that?
Yeah,
they're like fueled on Skittles and Cokes, and they're just doing it.
So come on down to Texas Bitcoin Conference in Austin. Go get the details over at TexasBitcoinConference.com and use code FTL when you're ordering your tickets to get a $25 discount on the already very affordable $150 admission fee. So knock $25 off by using code FTL. And another $25 when you use that code FTL will go towards Sean's Outpost to help with their outreach and assistance to the homeless. So we look forward to seeing you in Austin on March 28th and 29th at the Moody Theater in downtown Austin at Texas Bitcoin Conference. .com. 50 Shades of Grey. It is raking in millions of dollars at the box office this weekend in movie form. And the book, of course, was a big bestseller. There were two sequels. And what is it about? What is it about this book, this story, that is so attractive? One of our recent callers said that it's because the guy's rich. That's why this book has become so popular. That's what is making it so attractive. Would the book have been as attractive to people had he been a hobo? You know, some kind of wino having a BDSM relationship with some lady. No, certainly not. Probably.
And you could be rich and like wine.
Yeah, that's true. But a wino likes wine too much, right?
You can be rich and like wine too much.
Yeah, I guess that's true. Well, anyway, my point being, Mark, that it's interesting, and I don't think there is one real answer as to why things are the way they are. I like the speculation that the Puritan past of the United States is oppressing people sexually, and so that's, you know, maybe that's one reason why people are acting out in this way. But we had a guy call in earlier who said that he's always felt this way, that from birth, essentially, he's wanted to dominate people in the bedroom.
Well, everybody's got something wrong with this movie. And this often happens when something's a phenomenon, right? Everybody who's got an axe to grind, and there's a lot of axes out there that need a good grinding as far as people are concerned, they'll jump in. So the Christians don't like it because, you know, it's not appropriate behavior or something like that. The feminists don't like it because it's the gal getting the spankings or whatever. I mean, if it was an empowered rich woman who is doling out spankings to an attractive young man, then perhaps some of the feminists would think that was okay. But then some of the feminists wouldn't like it because it was a man at all or whatever. Mm-hmm. I mean, everybody's got an axe to grind. I don't, I mentioned the spanking thing, corporal punishment. And there's plenty of the corporal punishment people out there that have the anti-corporal punishment people out there that have a problem with BDSM because they feel that it's an outcropping of this. There are those like you, the sex positive people, that believe for whatever reason that
sex positive. What's that mean?
Sex positive basically means that we think sex is a good thing.
Oh, right.
Get out there and do some sex.
Well, hold that thought, Mark, because we got lots of people who want to talk here. We've got Straight Razor. That's the name of the person calling from Dallas. Straight Razor. You're on Free Talk Live.
Hello, how you doing, gentlemen? So I'm calling in because obviously there's a myriad of reasons why people either are the way they are or choose to become certain things. However, I think one big part of this could possibly be that people are yearning for something real. And I mean, what's more
like a real,
real
spanking?
Like, what's more real than feeling pain? Because if you look at everything that's going on in the world today, look at these fake-faced politicians, all the lies that are out there, all the fallacies that are just surrounding you in the world. It's kind of like, why did you gentlemen move to Keene? Because you wanted to be surrounded by people with the same ideas and make them into a reality in a place so that people could see, hey, this is a real thing, and you wanted to feel that reality yourselves in that lifetime.
Makes sense.
So, you know, once you start yearning for that, and people are going to take it out in different ways. You know, you guys become activists, or you talk about your ideas and express them out on the airwaves. Well, someone else might express that through feeling pain or seeing someone else experience pain.
It's certainly true that pain is something that you can definitely take notice of in life. It demands attention. And although it seems that people wouldn't really want to subject themselves to that. I mean, generally, humans tend to gravitate towards that which gives them pleasure.
Right. Pain is the sort of thing that you're supposed – it's supposed to be a warning that bad things are happening. I mean, it's a warning from your body, right?
Well, absolutely. But let's say, for instance, you get pleasure from something that tells you every day.
Something that you cut out for a moment there.
Let's say your spouse tells you that they love you every single day,
okay,
but then
sure.
you found out, but then you find out that wasn't true. Okay. Mm-hmm. So that feeling, what was giving you that positive feeling wasn't real. So you weren't actually experiencing it at the time you felt it was real, but it actually wasn't. Well, then maybe you crave something that is literally hard-lined. It is by nature you're going to feel it.
That there's no doubt, right? Like if there's a riding crop being strapped across your butt, then there's no doubt that that's real, is what you're saying.
Absolutely.
And that there's something that is grounding about that, something that people are desiring at some kind of basic level.
Exactly, because everybody wants to. I mean, that's kind of like. You can live in your own little world, and you can have experiences that you feel are real, but eventually, the veil can come down, and at that point, you're going to crave to feel something that is actually there.
Yeah, so, I think there's some value to what you're saying.
Interesting. Straight Razor, thanks for the call tonight. Appreciate hearing from you. Let's continue here and talk to Allison, listening in Lynchburg, Virginia, to WLNI-FM. Hello, Allison.
Hey, I'm about to blow your mind a little bit.
Ooh, okay. Usually I have to pay for that, but go ahead.
Okay, I am a Christian. I have been spanked as a kid. Guess what? I don't want to get spanked by my man. Have you? But at the same time, I'm not going to yell my keister off at somebody who chooses to behave the way that numbskulls in the book do. There's something in
the
Bible.
Have you read the book?
Really...
Hold on. Have you read 50 Shades of Grey?
Oh, no. I'm not even going to get close to it because I know I'm going to be yelling at people in the first chapter.
All right.
I don't even go to drama movies. I can't stand them. I can't handle them. I yell at people for action movies. Remember the movie Stealth?
No.
Stealth?
I was yelling at the computer plane.
I'm concerned you need to check your blood pressure. I'm one of these yellers, too, and I found out that I've got pretty high blood pressure.
Well, that's why I avoid it, because I know that there's a risk of a high blood pressure, so I don't go that direction.
Okay.
But in the Bible, I am a Christian, so I do quote the Bible a lot. It's very important to me.
Well, you hold that thought. Hold that thought. We'll come back to you here, Allison. So you're saying you're a Christian, but you're not passing judgment on the people who are into BDSM?
Not, because there's a deeper purpose.
Stand by. We'll get to your thoughts here in a moment. Free Talk Live.
Shiny badges on your jacket. Shiny badges.
This is Davi Barker from ShinyBadges.com, and I just want to personally apologize for airing a jingle week after week, month after month, that turned out to be such an infectious brain worm. So to make it up to you, I'm offering a free gift. The next time you make a purchase at ShinyBadges.com, write WORMS in the transaction comments, and I'll send you something weird.
In a trial by jury, the primary function of a juror is not to dispense punishment to the accused. It is to protect your fellow citizens from being unjustly deprived of their life, liberty, or property. As a juror, you can say no to unjust laws and prevent government abuses of power by refusing to convict. Legislative, executive, judicial. The fourth branch of government is we the people. Find out more from the Fully Informed Jury Association at fija.org.
I love my magic mud. I drink a lot of coffee. I had stains on my teeth. Then I found my magic mud, and I was told it would remove stains. So I paid attention when I brushed the first time. My magic mud is black tooth powder, and the difference it made in my teeth in one application was noticeable. With four, my teeth were as white as you normal folks out there. Please go to mymagicmud.com and buy a jar. There's 150 applications for $25. You can use Bitcoin. Mymagicmud.com.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number three is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
This is the Liberty Beat, your daily source for Liberty news and activist updates. Online at thelibertybeat.com. I'm Brian Hagan with your Liberty Beat for Friday, February 13th, 2015. Gold opened today at $1,230, up $6. Silver opened at $17.32, up 41 cents, and Bitcoin is trading around $236. Today's Bitcoin price brought to you by ExpressCoin, the fastest, most reliable way to buy Bitcoin. Buy Bitcoin today at ExpressCoin.com. Extreme weather, from droughts lasting for weeks and torrential rainstorms robbing the country of vital crops for food, to snowstorms of 70 inches plus, stopping cities in their tracks. Supporting your family through these difficult times is what eFoods Direct does. Go to eFoodsDirect.com/LibertyBeat or call 800-620-5520 to learn more about food security in a time of crisis. In the news, on Thursday, doctors and health professionals representing seven countries released a letter warning that the controversial Trans-Pacific Partnership trade agreement will lead to higher medical costs for all nations. The letter, published in the Lancet Medical Journal, states that rising medicine costs would disproportionately affect already vulnerable populations. The doctors called on the governments involved in the trade deal to publicly release the full text of the agreement. An international committee of scientists have released a report stating that geoengineering techniques are not a viable alternative to reducing greenhouse gas emissions to combat the effects of climate change. The committee report called for more research and the understanding of various geoengineering techniques before implementation. The scientists found that certain techniques are likely to present serious known and possible unknown environmental, social, and political risks, including the possibility of being deployed unilaterally. The report was sponsored by the National Academy of Sciences, the U.S. Intelligence Community, NASA, NOAA, and the U.S. Department of Energy. The Sacramento County Sheriff's Department is seeking to upgrade its cell phone surveillance tools. That's according to recently revealed documents. News 10 Sacramento reports the department filed an application for a new $300,000 Stingray cell site simulator in August of 2013. Stingrays work by tricking cell phones into sending data to the devices as if it were a cell tower. Despite evidence that the department is using the tools, no requests for search warrants have been made. The Liberty Beat is sponsored by the Texas Bitcoin Conference. Hear from speakers like Charlie Shrem, Dr. Robert Murphy, Vitalik Buterin, and Catherine Bleich. March 28th and 29th at ACL Live at the Moody Theater. Tickets on sale now, TexasBitcoinConference.com. Support also comes from Central Texas Gunworks, your online source for firearms, firearm accessories, and ammunition. They take major credit cards and now accept Bitcoin. Visit them online, shop.centraltexasgunworks.com. This is the Liberty Beat for Friday, February 13th, 2015. Check out the website at thelibertybeat.com. Former intelligence analyst and whistleblower Chelsea Manning has been granted approval for hormone treatment for a gender transition. Officials with the Department of Defense stated the therapy was approved on February 5th. The announcement follows a lawsuit filed in D.C. last September, where Manning stated she was at risk for suicide if not given treatment for gender dysphoria. Manning is currently serving a 35-year prison sentence for leaking classified documents to WikiLeaks. First Nations people of Southeast Alaska are facing threats to their traditions and way of life from large mining operations. The United Tribal Transboundary Mining Work Group and Haida Indian Tribes of Alaska are calling on the state of Alaska and the U.S. State Department to stop destructive mining operations, including mines in British Columbia, such as Red Chris, until further studies are conducted. The groups are calling for bans on watered tailings dams in response to a recent engineering report on the causes of a recent spill. The report highlighted shortcomings in designs and maintenance. The Liberty Beat is made possible by CoinArch, offering innovative trading solutions for Bitcoin. Do more than just buy and sell Bitcoin. Use long and short positions to profit in rising and falling markets, and to boost your returns through leverage. Visit CoinArch.com and sign up using coupon code MAX and get free brokerage for the first 7 days. That's CoinArch.com. Support also comes from Midas Resources Incorporated, helping clients convert their paper 401ks and IRAs to solid gold and silver. Get their 10 Reasons book free by calling 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237. This is the Liberty Beat for Friday, February 13th, 2015. I'm Brian Hagan, reporting, reminding you, spread liberty with a smile.
George W. Bush may be retired from politics, but he's keeping busy with his new hobby of painting. Today, the Picasso-in-Chief tweeted his latest picture, a turkey sandwich and glass of lemonade in front of the ghost of the Iraqi child that follows him everywhere. Rebecca Mira has been following the flourishing art career. He's pretty good, Rebecca.
Yeah, well, Rachel, Bush doesn't claim to be a great artist, but as he put it, not bad for an old man, huh?
Not bad at all. He says he likes painting simple things he sees in everyday life, like his dogs, that dead Iraqi child. You can see that Bush's art is improving over time. If you take a look, at first he could barely draw the Iraqi child's transparent hands, but now they look much more realistic.
Much more. You know, I'm not surprised that he's getting better. Bush practices constantly.
And Laura Bush says he's more focused than ever, locks himself away for hours at a time, and won't talk to anyone while he's painting.
Yeah.
Makes you wonder if history will look back on Bush as a politician or the next Rembrandt. Up next, a study found that drinking red wine once a day can help the body get hammered.
This is the Onion News Network.
This is Free Talk Live. You can dial in toll-free here and bring up whatever you'd like. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. If you're just tuning into the show tonight, we're in our third, just kicking off our third hour here with you. It's Ian.
And Mark.
We've been talking about 50 Shades of Grey from a point of the ignorant outsiders, because Mark, you and I have not read 50 Shades of Grey, nor have we seen the new movie that apparently was just released yesterday. That has broken box office records already in just one day with $30 million in ticket sales. The movie is on track to be the most popular, the most well-sold Valentine's Day weekend movie of all time, apparently.
Yeah, and it's a fan fiction of Twilight, and it's probably going to outsell their movies.
Yeah, I couldn't tell you about that, but the larger conversation that's been going on has not been about the movie itself or how well acted or well shot or what the story exactly is, but more so about what is it tapping into? Why is this movie as popular as it is? Why are the book series as popular as they are? And what does it really mean? We've actually got somebody who's been hanging on waiting through the break to continue a discussion. We've heard from different sides so far tonight. We've had people who are inside or have been inside the BDSM scene. And also we've had folks calling in who've sort of been passing judgment and saying that those people are of the devil or that they are filthy and unhealthy and lots of, lots of terms like that. Sort of adverbs?
Filthy. Yep.
Yeah. Have been leveled at the people who are into this lifestyle. Allison.
No, those are adjectives.
L-Y, isn't
L-Y. That? Filthy, not filthily.
I don't know. Allison, you're on Free Talk Live. So you were saying a moment ago that you are a Christian, and that you're not offended by the fact that people are engaging in this lifestyle? I don't want to put words in your mouth. Do we have Allison? Allison in Lynchburg? Maybe there's some technical difficulties. Her line is still active, so hopefully we'll see if we can get her on here in just a moment, because I was curious to know where she was going to go with her thoughts on this. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. So, you know, there have been speculation here tonight as to where's this come from. Some have suggested, the guy Abel Freeman called in earlier, suggesting that maybe the Puritan past has a lot to do with the sexual repression, which may manifest itself in the United States in the form of unusual sexual proclivities. But maybe,
a practitioner called in and he said he was born that way.
He said he was born that way, and maybe this isn't that unusual. You know, maybe this is more common than people would like to believe who don't much care for it. And maybe it's more common than maybe people who even are into the scene really had thought previously. Maybe a lot of people have just been keeping their preferences quiet on this. And now, due to the popularity of this film and the book series that preceded it, maybe that's sparking more conversation about sex. And I think that's what's healthy. I think people actually having conversation about sex is a healthy thing to do. I think it's unhealthy to repress the discussion about these things and these issues and kinks and fetishes and things like that. Now, obviously, there's only so far we can go with a conversation about sex on nationally syndicated talk radio. So, for instance, if you are doing a radio show, you can't be indecent, as they say, if it's before 10 o'clock at night, and you can't
be indecent after 10 o'clock at night.
And you can't be obscene, as they call it, at any time. And usually obscenity describes some discussion of extricatory and
sexually purient nature.
Yeah, extricatory functions and also sex, basically, in a very very detailed kind of manner. But we can still come at it from a clinical perspective and psychological perspective, and I think that's, you know, what we've been doing as much as we can here tonight. We've got her back. Allison is back, listening in Virginia. Are you there, Allison?
Yes, I'm here. Excellent. I'm sorry about that. Maybe.
Can you do me a favor before you go on? Back off your phone about, I don't know, 2 inches or something like that, and that way we're not going to hear little distortions that we've been hearing in your call.
My voice carries. Sorry about
that's perfect.
That.
Yeah.
Okay, well, go ahead with your thoughts. What did you want to share with our audience tonight?
Well, there's an underlying situation involved that all this seems to stem from. The older I get, okay, so I'm not in my 20s anymore. But the older I get, the more I see it. Now, in the Bible, I do a lot of Bible. In Jeremiah 17, verse 9, the heart is deceitful above all things and desperately wicked. Who can know it? If the heart of a person, right from the get-go, like my little one-year-old, already has that built in, then things are going to get cranky quickly.
If the heart has what built in? I couldn't quite make it out.
Deceit.
The what? The
deceit.
Seat?
I mean, deceit. The heart is deceitful in all things.
You're saying that people are by nature deceitful?
Yes. Even my one-year-old shows it.
Oh, yeah. People tell lies. There's no doubt about it. I mean, and it's shown in kids that they can be deceitful, too. Absolutely.
Exactly.
But I mean, don't you think that says it's what you tend to look? It was what you choose to look at, though. I mean, like, there's people are also tell the truth. They're honest. They're open. They're loving. There's all kinds of things. Don't
right.
you think that statement says a lot about Jeremiah and very little about anything else?
Well, actually, I see it in myself too. And the ones that the
sure.
people that are good people are the ones who recognize that in themselves and fight it.
Sure, I'm with you.
What does that have to do with BDSM, 50 Shades of Grey, sexual kinks? I'm not sure.
How does that relate to you in your mind?
Okay, the way it relates in my mind is that it can very quickly become an addiction situation where it's not recognized by the person who's doing these activities that this is feeding the evil side of themselves. So
why is it necessarily evil? Is it because, you know, people are being spanked? Is it because there's some level of consensual violence involved that it seems evil? I mean, people are consenting. How could that be considered evil?
Yes, people are consenting, but it does damage to the spirit. Even giving consent, it does damage to the spirit.
So,
but some Christians would say that about sex, period, right? Like sex outside of marriage, would that also damage the spirit as well, in your opinion?
It's like fire. If it's in a safe, area, say a grill, a fireplace, fire pit, then it's wonderful. But if it goes crazy, if it's out of its boundaries, then it can do 100,000 times more damage than positive. In the Bible...
Well, the Bible says that the marriage bed, the Bible's very clear that the marriage bed is undefiled, right? Like, you know.
Exactly. It's good stuff. It's actually blessed.
So then why in the world can't husbands and wives, you know, smack each other on the butts with whatever it is that they wish to do? I mean, why does it suddenly become defiled and evil when, like, I don't understand. I mean, sex is, it's blessed in the Bible, supposedly.
Right. It's blessed in the Bible within the framework. But if a husband and wife want to, well, okay, pull out the fuzzy handcuffs and get a little naughty, well, that's between them. I don't want to know that. That's none of my significance.
So hold on. So what you're saying is that if, by your belief system, if a couple is together by under marriage, then it's not a bad thing for them to be engaged in BDSM activity?
So long as it's consensual.
Okay, but if it's outside of marriage, then you're saying it's like...
It outside of the framework where it's best built, then you got a fire in a leaf pile in the middle of a windy wood.
Thanks for the call tonight, Allison. I appreciate it. It's an interesting analogy, drawing a line between sex and fire, that you have to keep it in its proper place. And of course, she believes that the only proper place for that is after marriage, which I think is, personally, I find that unhealthy, to wait until you've entered into a lifelong contract with someone to decide to try sex. That sounds like a dangerous thing to do. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. What if you get married to somebody and then you find out you're not sexually compatible? That's going to be a pretty, pretty awful lifetime you're going to have there with that person. 855-450-FREE. And I'd imagine that would lead to some deceit later on. It's Free Talk Live. You can share your thoughts. More coming up.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing to be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. It's physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com.
This is Mark of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the economic engine that powers our country. With a printing press tethered to Washington bureaucrats and New York central bankers, how can we trust paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, or go to gold.freetalklive.com. Again, 877-357-9938, 877-357-9938.
Farmers keep livestock lean and healthy with a mineral-rich diet. Then, before market, they cut off minerals, leaving them to crave high-calorie grains. If weight control is this easy, why prescribe surgery for humans? Introducing Youngevity. You could avoid 900 diseases by getting 90 essential nutrients from Youngevity. Check out 90 for Life at tobeyoungagain.com or call 855-79-YOUNG. That's 855-79-YOUNG or tobeyoungagain.com. Youngevity. It's all about saving money, getting healthy, and creating wealth.
Free Talk Live.
To be free is to be clear-headed.
I encourage people.
Somebody gets down and smokes a joint and gets high. They sit on the couch and they turn into a blob.
Yeah, well, I don't think you know much about people that smoke pot, Christy.
Right. Yeah, Christy.
They procrastinate. That's what you guys were talking about on your show tonight.
So cliche.
Then, Christy, what I can say then is the people that don't smoke pot make sweeping generalizations, because you just did. It seems like the vast majority of humans use some kind of substance throughout their day or week.
Not Christy. She doesn't.
Well, what a sad, sad state of affairs.
Do you have a cup of coffee in the morning, Christy?
At this time in our history, if that's...
We've always done it. Christy, it's been done through our humans. People, well, how many people do you know, Christy, that can't function without a cup of coffee?
Well, you have to have a bread, you know, piece of bread to live, to survive.
We're not talking about food.
Free Talk Live, 7 nights a week from 7 to 10 Eastern, live on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com. Nothing compares to a good cup of coffee. But if you're getting your coffee from the store, you're likely not getting a good cup of coffee. Free Talk Live's teamed up with BuzzBox to bring you a free pound of the best coffee, shade-grown, organic, top 1% grade Arabica. But what's different is that for every 10 people that get coffee through our link, coffee.freetalklive.com, we can give another microloan through Kiva. When the loan's paid, we lend the money again. Help others, one cup at a time, coffee.freetalklive.com.
This is the Liberty Radio Network, broadcasting the latest liberty-oriented audio content 24 hours a day at LRN.FM.
Free Talk Live. Dial toll-free to bring up whatever you'd like here toll-free tonight at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Joining you in studio, it's me, Ian.
And me, Mark.
Coming up, you can join us on our remote studio, or at our remote studio at the New Hampshire Liberty Forum. It's coming up the 5th of March through the 8th. That's a Thursday through Sunday, and we'll look forward to seeing you there. We're at the Liberty Forum every single day. You can join us there and join hundreds of other like-minded, liberty-oriented folks for a great time with all kinds of guest speakers, keynote speakers, including Ben Swan this year, the gentleman from the founder of Overstock.com will be there.
Patrick Byrne,
and also Jeffrey Tucker is back keynote speaking at the New Hampshire Liberty Forum, as well as dozens of other speakers and panelists and discussions, and of course the hundreds of attendees that you'll get to know and get to know some of them. Many of whom will be your future neighbors if you end up making the move to New Hampshire, as we did as part of the Free State Project. And to some extent, that's kind of what the Liberty Forum is it shows off the amazing community of liberty-minded folks that we have here in New Hampshire. You go to nhlibertyforum.com. You can learn more about the event there. But I've got a new special offer. We had been giving away some tickets previously to people who'd registered hotel rooms by a certain date. That date has passed, so too late to get that offer. But there's another offer on the table, which is a little different, and it's only available to certain individuals. So if you are already a Free State Project participant, meaning if you've signed up for the Free State Project, sorry, you don't qualify for this deal. You have to not be a Free State Project participant to qualify for this. And in addition, you have to not be a Free State Project participant and not live in New Hampshire. So you can't live in New Hampshire and you can't be a Free State Project participant yet. Following me, Mark?
Yep.
Okay. So you're disqualified from this. but if you meet those qualifications, then I can get you a free ticket to the Liberty Forum. See, the idea behind the Liberty Forum is we want to show off the community here, and so if you aren't yet a Free State Project signer, then we're hoping you'll be a Free State Project signer by the end of the weekend. And so they're asking, in return for getting a free ticket to the Liberty Forum, you have to commit to attending the FSP questions session on Saturday at the Liberty Forum. So if you're willing to commit to going to one of the myriad of events happening at the Liberty Forum, then you
we'll
can
copy
get
a ticket.
You can get a ticket.
I'm excited by it.
For free. All you have to do is email me, ian@freetalklive.com. Let me know your name and let me know you'll commit to attend that particular function. It's Saturday. It's about noon 30. Carla Mora will be leading this session. Now, Carla is a super activist. She
Dynamo.
Is an awesome Liberty Lady. She's actually right now down in Washington, D.C. at the Students for Liberty International Conference or whatever they're calling it, but a very large conference also happening in D.C. She's kind of down there pushing the Free State Project. She's great. I mean, she can handle any of these questions. Whatever questions you throw at her, she'll be able to handle it. It's not required that you ask a question. They're just requiring that you attend that particular seminar at the New Hampshire Liberty Forum. In return, you get a basic ticket for free. You want that ticket? You want to lock it down? Just get in touch with me. You've got till the end of the month to do this. So email me, ian@freetalklive.com, and I will get your information to the organizer, and she'll lock down your ticket. Make sense?
That easy.
All right. So 855-450-FREE is the toll-free number. 50 Shades of Grey. Very, very popular. But why? Let's go to Michael listening in St. George, Utah. You're on Free Talk Live. Hello, Michael.
Hey, how's it going, guys?
Welcome, sir. Go ahead with your thoughts.
Yeah, I've just been listening in, and I've been listening to almost the world or the world around me about this whole ordeal about it. It doesn't affect me directly, but I kind of wanted to put my two cents in about it.
When you say it, you're talking about 50 Shades of Grey?
Yeah, yes, okay. Yes. People are getting all over obsessive about sex before marriage. Sex is a natural human thing. Our bodies do it. We need to do it. Create more people. But also I feel like when people are into those different kinks or those different fetishes, I feel like people are almost, I would dare to say, born that way, kind of how people are born gay or, mm-hmm. The different ethnicities people are born. Because when I talk about pornography with my friends, different stuff that we're into or whatever, everybody's different. We're all into different things. Now, I'm married. I do have a child. But me and my wife, we had premarital sex, and I feel like it hasn't affected our relationship at all to this point. I think people are making way too big of a deal over it, but I don't know. That's my.
So you're coming from the perspective saying that you believe that sexual proclivities are innate, that they are you are born with whatever it is that your kinks are.
Yeah, I mean, if you go to a different porn site, they all have different. There are different sections dedicated to each one, depending on what you're into. So, there's a huge spectrum out there, a broad spectrum of it, and I believe that you are born into it. I mean, I'm into certain things, my friends are into certain things, my wife's into certain things.
Sure.
So,
the one thing I'd say is, interjecting here is I've talked to people who have the opinion that you shouldn't have sex before marriage. That's not my opinion, but I will say that I think that their point of view is not being properly viewed on this program. So what they're going to say is look, you don't know whether you match somebody if you don't have sex before marriage and you get together, you may not know you haven't developed tastes in sex, so therefore you're much more likely to match your partner. You were saying that what if you find out that your sexual preferences don't match? Well, you develop your sexual preferences over time through use. And
Yes. That's
so therefore, if you get together with somebody who you've never had sex or whatever, your preferences are likely to be similar. You're going to be attracted.
Interesting theory.
You're going to be – well, I mean, I wouldn't say that it's true all the time, but I wouldn't say anything's true all the time.
Hmm. Michael, thanks for the call tonight. I appreciate hearing from you. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. So, Mark, you're saying that, and this isn't what you're propagating. You're just saying some people have said this.
I'm going to say that I think that this is, to some extent, true.
Meaning that if two people do not have sex, they've never had sex, and then they have sex for the first time after they get married, that you're saying they might be a blank slate, and so therefore...
slate, right? Uh-huh. So you don't know... I'm trying to think of what these proclivities are, but I mean, if you're going to...
Well, we're talking about BDSM here. Yep. That's been the general discussion tonight.
So at that point, it's likely that you're going to go... A lot of people out there are going to do whatever it is that their partner wants done as far as these fantasies go. And so you're going to like it more or less. And... if you don't allow yourself the out of saying, well, if I just don't like her particular fantasies, whatever they might be, I can always go find another. There's plenty of fish in the sea.
But you're already married at that point.
Right. At that point, no, you don't allow yourself that out. You're like, this is what my wife likes. I do what my wife likes because it's what she likes. Right. Like, that's an entirely different mindset.
You can share your thoughts. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Now, of course, that viewpoint flies in the face of the viewpoint that people are predetermined from birth to have certain
I don't believe that
kinks.
Crap at all. I mean, that sounds like absolute nonsense to me. I mean, I understand
that's what
people
the guy who's called earlier
fine.
Said.
He can
he's
have
BSing
it,
you?
No.
He says he's always felt like dominating women in a bedroom.
I don't think people know what motivates them. I think that that people's psyches are largely opaque to themselves. Mine would be opaque to me, and his would be opaque to him. I think that, how would he know if he had some kind of sexual imprinting that was done, and I don't mean that somebody touched him or anything like that, but some kind of imprinting that was done when he was three. He'd think he was born that way.
Like walking into mom and dad in the
who
bedroom
knows?
Or something? 855-450-FREE is the toll-free number. You can share your thoughts on Free Talk Live.
This is Rick Osick, president of Famous Footwear. Our company is working together with the March of Dimes through March for Babies to raise money and awareness about the serious problem of premature birth in the U.S. As a business leader, I know that babies born very sick or too soon cost businesses billions of dollars each year, in addition to the emotional stress on employees and their families. That's why Famous Footwear is committed to raising funds to improve the health of moms and babies everywhere. Won't you please join us in the March for Babies? Start a team today at marchforbabies.org.
How many good people procrastinate? When was the last time you updated your last will and testament, your living will, and your health care power of attorney? If you could get these documents included with your Legal Shield membership for no additional charge, wouldn't it just make sense to have the peace of mind of owning a Legal Shield membership? Worry less and live more with lsprotection.com. That's lsprotection.com or call 855-340-SAVE. That's 855-340-7283.
Results will vary from case to case.
Hi, I'm Derek J. To me, an activist's calling is to actively work to advance a cause. The cause for which I work is personal freedom. I believe my life is best when I engage in voluntary interactions and self-government. I reject the idea that anyone else has a higher claim to my life or my body than I do. I see people who call themselves the government as a threat to my personal freedom. I realize you may feel differently, but my relationship with the people who call themselves the government is completely involuntary. If Starbucks used some of its money to drop bombs, I wouldn't shop there. So why would I support the American Empire? The Empire does not require my consent.
Derek J's Victimless Crime Spree. Watch it for free and order the Director's Cut DVD at victimlesscrimespree.com. That's victimlesscrimespree.com.
Ross Ulbricht was convicted in early 2015 of running the infamous Silk Road Underground Market. The Silk Road was a gift to humanity and helped reduce the harms brought on by drug prohibition. For this good deed, Ross may be spending the rest of his life in prison. His family is planning to appeal his conviction, but they need your support. Please visit FreeRoss.org, where you can contribute via various methods, including Bitcoin. Ross needs your help now more than ever. Visit FreeRoss.org. That's FreeRoss.org. You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone. 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
Listen, you've heard the commercials before. Whether you owe $15,000 or $15 million in tax debt to the IRS or state, we can help. On a never-ending payment plan? Penalties and interest killing you? Missing tax returns? Being garnished or levied? Not a problem. If you qualify, we can remove levies and garnishments within days or even hours of hiring our firm. If you've been summoned, or even worse, receiving tax warrants in the mail, call right now. Are you a business owner with back payroll taxes? Is the IRS or state threatening to close your business you've worked so hard to build? Protect yourself and your business. Even if you've tried in the past, new guidelines could potentially qualify you today. So what are you waiting for? We can take that tax monkey off your back.
Call the tax monkey now. 800-281-6030. 800-281-6030. 800-281-6030. That's 800-281-6030.
You can sign up to receive the latest about the Liberty Radio Network via our email updates at updates.lrn.fm. That's updates.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. You can bring up anything you want. Just dial in toll-free here at 855-450-FREE. Joining you tonight on this live Saturday edition, you've got me, Ian.
And me, Mark.
And we invite you to our website over at freetalklive.com. Do enjoy the features that we share with you. If you like Free Talk Live and you want to help support the show, then become an amplifier over at amp.freetalklive.com. Normally, the AMP program is $5 a month. You get perks. You get these benefits for being an amplifier, like access to the AMP-only call-in lines, the AMP-only podcast, as well as the AMP-only Facebook group, which is actually a pretty popular place. Lots of posts being made there on a weekly basis, if not a daily basis, on the AMP-only Facebook group. You get access to all of that and more by becoming an amplifier. And it helps us out, too, because that money, that $5 a month, is being invested into Free Talk Live so we can get on more radio stations to talk about, in general, the ideas of freedom, although tonight we've been talking more about sex. And anything goes here on Free Talk Live. But if you like what we're doing, please get behind the show as an amplifier over at amp.freetalklive.com. And every now and then, we come up with something, and actually, we didn't come up with this, but we have someone who's got good ideas come up with something really unique. And one of our listeners, who is also an amplifier, has put his own money on the line to create a brand new amp-only T-shirt. And this shirt is
more than a T-shirt. It's like one of those technical wicking fabric things.
It's a shirt, though, right?
It's like a long-sleeve shirt.
Oh, it's long-sleeved. Okay, so T-shirt's not the right term, then. Thank you for that correction. A long-sleeve shirt on a tech fabric with a word cloud design. He took a bunch of our show descriptions, and I'm not sure for what time frame, but he took a bunch of show descriptions for Free Talk Live.
He's an engineer. He did it in a pretty technical fashion, whatever he did.
Plugged it into one of these word cloud generators and made a word cloud of our topics and made that into a T-shirt. It looks great. Mark, we made shirt.freetalklive.com, I believe, that people can go to if you want to take a look at what this shirt looks like. Or at least the mock-up of what it will look like, because it hasn't actually been printed yet. But shirt.freetalklive.com will take you to the pictures. It's a cool-looking shirt, and I know that Michael, who created this, is really excited about getting these out there. But what we've done was, or what we've done, is turn this into kind of a fundraiser for Free Talk Live, meaning that you have to be a Free Talk Live Platinum amplifier to qualify to get this shirt.
It is an amplifier shirt.
Correct. But it's only for Platinum amplifiers, and Platinum is the highest level of amplification. You can do $5 a month, that's silver, $10 a month, gold, and we certainly appreciate everybody who does those things. Michael is a Platinum amplifier, and he just wanted to do something to encourage more people to get to that level. And so if you want to qualify for the shirt, the rules are very simple. You have to be a Platinum amplifier by the 1st of March. And you have to remain a Platinum amplifier for at least a couple months, meaning through the 1st of
May.
So you've got
a couple. It's not the 1st, though. He moved it to the 8th because he wants people to be able to sign up for the Liberty Forum.
I didn't know that we were announcing that in advance, Mark. I thought that there was some discussion about that, but that it hadn't been confirmed.
Okay,
so,
I'm not sure then.
I thought that there was a possibility that we would extend it through Liberty Forum, but that would depend on certain things.
Okay.
But either way, you've got a couple months. You've got a couple weeks to get signed up for this. You've got to be a Platinum amplifier by the 1st of March. Go to amp.freetalklive.com. If you're already an amplifier, you can obviously upgrade. If you're not yet an amplifier or you were formerly an amplifier, we'd love to have you back. We'd love to have you back, or we'd have love to have you on board over at amp.freetalklive.com. To the phones and the fun, Joy's listening in Muncie, Indiana, to WIBC. Hello, Joy, or Jay, excuse me.
Jay.
Apologize about that, Jay.
The real problem with what we're talking about here is the 50 Shades of Grey thing. It's a control issue thing, whether it be in a sub and dom relationship, whether the woman needs the control in her life or the male needs to be in control. It's a complete reversal. And 95% of the time, women are in control.
Okay.
Well, the statement that was made earlier tonight is that the person who is the submissive in a dom-sub relationship is actually, in point of fact, in control because it's an act of consent and they set the boundaries at all times as far as how far people are willing to go.
Not in that perspective of what I'm talking. They have control problems themselves, whether it be they have to control certain situations of their lives or other people's lives to be able to function normally.
You're saying the submissive is the person with control problems or the dominant is?
Both people do. Whether it be the submissive needing the control of the dominant person to be able to cope with regular reality, I guess.
You know, I can't entirely disagree with this.
So he's saying this is a coping mechanism?
It's a harsh thing to say, but I... Well,
can you restate what's being said, Mark, then, if you're agreeing with this?
Okay, so what I'm hearing is that this is an indication of sort of, you know, in one case, for me, what it means is this is a... It's an indication for the sub, the person who's subordinate or whatever, that they have... you know, too much around sort of, you know, their attention seeking, right? Like you're paying very close attention. If you're the dominant person, you're paying very close attention to this other person, right? Like they are the center of attention if they're getting spanked or whatever.
Okay.
And then, so, you know, hey.
How's that different from any other sex? I mean, the person is giving you attention in regular sex too.
It doesn't take as long.
Go ahead. It also involves with the controlling part of their lives. They have to have that to function.
They have to have this the BDSM sex to function, or the
just the BDSM in general. It doesn't have to involve the sex. People do the things like tie people up and leave them tied up for I guess they call it torturing them and
without orgasm. That's true. That's a good point.
Exactly.
It's pretty common, but actually.
They need that to function in life. They don't need it to orgasm. And a lot of the people who are into this BDSM nature have really bad control problems, whether it be in their home lives or mentally.
You know, that does bring me back to a discussion we were having years ago on this program. One of the first guests we ever had was Miss Ann. She doesn't call herself that anymore. She's retired from being a professional dominatrix, actually there in the Indianapolis area is where she's from. And I remember that, you know, she described, we talked to her for quite a while, actually, about her experiences as a dominatrix. And, you know, she would talk about the businessman who would come in and, you know, he's busy telling everybody what to do all day. But in there, he wants to be dominated. And in that, you know, it wasn't about sex because it wasn't prostitution that she was doing. She was literally just dominating these men. And that's what they were seeking. Now, whether or not they were getting off on it is another question. But she certainly wasn't getting them off, was my understanding. The relationship.
She was pretty clear that that's not what was occurring.
Right. And they were paying her big money to do this.
Yeah.
Jay, thanks for the call tonight. Appreciate it, man. Let's continue here. Ron is listening in St. George, Utah, to KZNU. Hello, Ron.
Hello.
Hey there. You're on the air.
Love your show.
Thanks. Go ahead.
You just heard from somebody from St. George just a little bit earlier, and I know from sad experience that what he's saying is not completely true.
What's that? What was not true?
Well, it's not true. You know, these fetishes are a result of sexual addiction and pornographic addiction, and that's where they result from.
Upon what do you base that?
As a counselor and as somebody that has had a long history with these things, I know that these fetishes aren't totally natural, and they just don't result in normal sexuality. They result from people who have had long-term addictions with sexuality and pornography.
Well, what do you say to the guy who called earlier tonight and said that he has always had this desire, that as long as he can recall, he's wanted to dominate a woman in the bedroom?
I do not believe him. And I totally believe that, you know, to tie up and to, you know, and to make bondage and all of this stuff a part of sexuality is not the normal for any couple. And it's a result of him being a sexual addict and him being a pornographic addict. You know,
we actually haven't had anybody talk about porn addiction necessarily tonight. I guess there was a guy who called a little bit and talked a bit about different porn sites. But, you know, I can't just dismiss somebody who says, oh, well, I've always felt that way. I tend to take someone at their word when they say that. But thank you for the call tonight, Ron. I do appreciate hearing from you. It's another everybody's viewpoint is certainly valid from their perspective. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. What do you think? You're welcome to share your thoughts in the remaining moments of Free Talk Live, which are coming up next.
Majid lives in Nordevin, Armenia, with his wife, kids, and grandkids, all in the same house. They have cows, but to compete against the big ranchers, Majid needed to get a loan for more cattle. Free Talk Live helped him get a loan for the cows. He bought them, and now he's very happy with the expansion of his farm. You can help us help more people by getting your coffee through coffee.freetalklive.com. Make a difference, one cup at a time. Get a free pound to try out the subscription. Cancel at any time. coffee.freetalklive.com.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
This alert just came in. This special announcement is for business owners and leaders of organizations who've been waiting for the right time to build. General Steel has made it impossible to wait any longer with rock-bottom prices that could save you thousands. That's right, General Steel, America's leader in pre-engineered structures, is offering buildings at prices you will never see again. Don't miss these prices. A 50 by 100 for $35,000. You heard right, that's 5,000 square feet for $35,000. Manufacturers, if you need a larger building, try a 100 by 100 commercial building for $129,000. You can't afford to rent with these prices. Imagine a 70 by 100 foot church building for under $69,000. With the economy improving and interest rates still at historic lows, you can't afford to wait. So call 866-91-STEEL. Lock in your price now. Call 866-91-STEEL. That's 866-917-8335.
Free Press Publications is an independent, alternative media and publishing company founded in June 2009 with the mission of ensuring a free press for the freedom movement and is committed to spreading the message of peace, freedom, love, and liberty. FPP also gives new authors an avenue for publishing freedom-oriented material. FPP brings you daily news and commentary on the website fpp.cc, as well as a daily 5-minute newscast, FPP Radio News, and weekly news, views, and commentary in the FPP Freedom Minute and Peace, Love, Liberty Radio at fppradio.com, and the monthly newspaper FPP News at news.fpp.cc. Find FPP online at fpp.cc. That's fpp.cc, as in Creative Commons.
Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
Free speech is protected on the internet, right? Not always. Government agencies try to limit free speech and commerce on the net. Luckily, when they do, the Institute for Justice is there to defend your First Amendment right to free speech. IJ helped set the first federal precedent for internet free speech in 1999, and ever since has worked to prevent unconstitutional roadblocks in cyberspace. Visit our website today at ij.org.
What's up next? Visit the Liberty Radio Network program guide to find out at shows.lrn.fm. That's shows.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. I'm not going to give you the toll-free number at this point because our phones are loaded up. If you don't get in tonight with your thoughts, it's okay. We do a Sunday edition of the show, too. We're live Sundays. We're live weekdays. We're live Saturdays. Every single night of the week, we're here 7 to 10 at night Eastern time. If you want to get your thoughts in on any issue whatsoever, that's what we do here on Free Talk Live. And we are always here for you. And in those other 21 hours of the day, you can always visit our website at freetalklive.com. And you can grab archives there. You can download those. You can get interactive in various different ways. Create the content right there on the front page of the website. So go and enjoy. It's all there
there for free at freetalklive.com. Let's jump right back into your calls and thoughts. 50 Shades of Grey, it's bringing BDSM into, dinner conversation. People are talking about sexuality, and people have a lot of different opinions. We've heard quite a variety tonight here on the air on Free Talk Live. And honestly, when I started the show tonight, Mark, I just kind of picked this one out of thin air before we started.
We had, really, we were going to go with something else, and you just decided you wanted to go with it.
It wasn't something I brought to the table as show prep. You did. It was just something I saw this headline, and I thought, you know what? Let's see what people think about this. I didn't really know if it was going to go for more than a segment or two, but here we are at the end of hour number three. Let's go to your calls and thoughts, and first talk to Jeffrey in Mark and I's hometown of Sarasota, Florida. Jeffrey, you're on Free Talk Live, listening to WSRQ.
Hello. I just calling in. I want to disagree with what the guy before me said, Rod or whatever.
Okay.
I think that, fetishes and your sexual orientation and such is more something you're born with. Having said that,
what if you've got like an Asian porn fetish? Do you think you're born particularly liking people from the Far East?
Well, I mean, for the most part, I'm sure that, as you grow up, your environmental, everything else depends on it, too. But for the most part, I think this is something that's like subconsciously genetically programmed into you. I mean, having said that, I say this because I'm asexual, and this is coming from a completely different perspective. Being asexual, I have...
Can you hold that thought? Can you define asexual for listeners who may not know what that is?
Right. Asexual is a person who is not interested with any sexual contact, anything sexual with another human being. Sometimes, not even masturbation or anything sexual at all.
And so there are different levels of asexuality, from what I understand. It's from what I've read, there's about 1% maybe of people who are considered asexual, but within that 1%, there's a range, right? So as you said, maybe self-pleasuring is included, maybe not. So for your asexuality, is self-pleasuring included, or are you completely asexual in that you aren't interested in that either?
Completely, no libido at all.
Okay.
Were you struck in your crotch?
That's an insulting question.
No, it is
Mark.
Not. It is a medical question.
Well, this is something, when you become a teenager, things change and you start becoming attracted to people.
Yeah.
Well, this is just not something that happened to me, and I think it's really disgusting. Everything has to do with sex, but I'm not against anybody who...
So you're actively turned off by sex. Look, Mark, the reason I say that's insulting is because sex is a mental thing more than it is a physical thing.
No, sex is... Okay, so he says he has no libido. Libido is physical.
Sex drive.
Right? Like, it's hormonal, and his gonads produce hormones, okay? And some people sometimes are asexual because they've been struck in the crotch.
Okay, well, I understand where you're going with this, and let me say this. That doesn't mean that I don't have, erections or anything like that. How can I explain this? My gonads or whatever, they can be aroused, they can be turned on, but I feel nothing. It's like they're acting by themselves. It's like a whole separate, it's not even part of my body, it's just there.
Huh. That's interesting. When you're, when you see people, whether they're, opposite sex or the same sex as you.
Are there pretty people and ugly people?
Yeah. Can you discern, is there an attraction at all? Like, as far as I'd like to snuggle with that person, is there anything there at all as far as intimacy, of a desire for intimacy?
Try looking at this through the eyes of an 8-year-old. You see people, you can tell they're attractive or not, but you don't want to do anything with them. You just you just notice they're there.
Mm-hmm. I realize we've gone off into the world of talking to you about your asexuality, but I know you were calling with a purpose, so if you want to jump back on that, feel free.
Well, yeah, I just wanted to disagree with Rod because he said this is something that, you have to be pretty messed up in order to have certain fetishes or whatever. And I'm asexual, and I can tell that I have fetishes because
really?
My gonads react to certain things, and they're very specific things. But I'm not attracted to that. I don't want to engage in that kind of sexual activity.
It's fascinating.
So that's clearly not something that I chose to like or something like that. It's something I definitely
can you give us an example without being explicit Can you give us a clinical example of one of these fetishes that you have that you're not interested in acting upon?
Feet, for example.
Feet.
Yeah.
So you feel a stirring, some sort of physical sensation surrounding an attractive set of feet, but at the same time, mentally, there's a total disconnect.
Yeah, like, I can tell that it's a fetish because obviously if I look at hands, I don't get the same reaction or, you know, something else. But
it's fascinating.
Yeah, I don't feel anything mentally. It's like, it's not even part of my body. It's just something that's there that acts by itself.
Have you ever orgasmed? I mean, during your experiencing these physical sensations in your crotch, have you ever inadvertently brought yourself to orgasm, or has your body, have you ever gone through that process?
It's gone through the process, but I don't believe I've ever gotten to orgasm.
You would know.
Although maybe I wouldn't recognize it. No, then definitely not. I would know.
At least I would think that you would know. Generally,
yeah. Generally males know.
Jeffrey, it's fascinating. I wish we had more time to talk to you about it. Feel free to call back any other night if you want to talk about being an asexual, because I think it's an unusual perspective that people just don't hear much about. I thank you for the call tonight. I want to make sure we do get a chance to get some other folks in here. David, listening in Florida to WYOO. Hello, David.
Yeah. Hey, good evening, guys. I wish I'd have called in earlier and everything, but basically, I want to debunk the one guy that said that, you have to be, if you have an addiction to porn, which I've had addiction to porn ever since I've been 8 years old.
What?
And
do you, when you're 8 years old, I mean, how old are you now?
I'm 47.
So at 8 years old, you only had access to magazines, right? I mean,
he found dad's magazines or found them in the woods.
Yeah, is that what happened? Was it dad's collection?
Yeah, dad's collection. I discovered masturbation. My first sexual encounter was 11 years old.
Okay.
With a girl who was the same age and everything. And I have seen some, over the many years, I have seen some pretty twisted things. But I have never acted on the things that I was like, no, that's something that is just... there's something wrong with that person and stuff. So, but I can, I can truly say, because at a point in time in my life, I was so obsessed with porn and everything that in school, basically I was having fantasies and I had to be excused to myself to the bathroom. And sometimes I stayed in there for a good 2 hours.
Oh boy, that's not going to go well.
I mean, yeah. So, I mean, and so, to debunk him, because, people in church and everything, they think that, porn, sexual encounters and everything, the church has put a stigma on it when it needs to be taught more in the church, because then it would take the stigma off of it.
What needs to be taught in church? Is people be more sexually open?
No, I mean, being more sexually open with your wife and everything, and teaching about sex and teaching about... what it could possibly lead to. I mean, so
yeah, there's a lot of shame,
the dangers of it, and what lifestyles can come out of it. Not saying that it's nasty or anything, but yes, I've come close, but I've been able to stop myself. Some people have no self-control, can't say no.
Yeah, I'd say there's a lot of shame around sexuality, and I was raised in the church too. And I'd say that the largest disservice that the church does, to married people is this shame, because then you can't even share with your wife or husband what it is that you want and you desire.
And you have to keeping that buried throughout an entire relationship. That's not good for you. David, thanks for the call tonight. We're out of time, but I do appreciate hearing from you. And to anyone else who is on hold, there's at least four more people here that we did not get on. I apologize about that. I always feel bad about the people at the end of the show. But we have another show tomorrow night. It's the Live Sunday Edition. You can call in and bring up the same topic if you felt like you didn't get your thoughts out there and you want to be heard. We're here for you. That's what we do 7 nights a week. So join us online between now and then over at freetalklive.com. And you, please, enjoy your weekend. On Free Talk Live, we're bringing people to the ideas of liberty every day.
From wrestling superstars like Glenn Jacobs.
You guys really are having an impact, I believe. Like I said, a lot of where I am now is due to listening to Free Talk Live. You changed my mind on some very important issues years ago.
To random people tuning in on the radio.
I was kind of stuck in the left-right paradigm. I heard your show by chance on a Saturday night. From there, I went on, joined the Free State Project, and become an amplifier. So, I mean, that's really the reason why I amp is because I know that if it wasn't for you guys being on as many stations as you are, I never would have found the ideas of Liberty.
Your amp will directly change more lives by getting Free Talk Live in front of people looking for talk radio online and on the air. You can help by joining the AMP program for just $5 a month at amp.freetalklive.com and getting perks. That's amp.freetalklive.com.
This is Mark of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the economic engine that powers our country. With a printing press tethered to Washington bureaucrats and New York central bankers, how can we trust paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, or go to gold.freetalklive.com. Again, 877-357-9938. 877-357-9938. The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
The live edition of Off the Air Live is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network, LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Saturday, February 14th, 2015. Silver is trading at $17.36 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,230 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $245. Antiwar.com reports Pentagon officials claimed on Friday that the Islamic State attempted to attack an Ayn al-Assad airbase where U.S. ground troops were stationed but failed before they got too close to the U.S. troops. Details are scant, but the Pentagon narrative is that an unknown number of the Islamic State forces who were part of the group that took the town of Baghdadi got into a battle with Iraqi ground troops who managed to repel them. It is unclear whether the Islamic State forces made a serious move towards the base or were simply reconnoitering after taking Baghdadi, a town just 5 miles away from the base. The reports are intended to ease concerns that U.S. troops who were positioned at the front line base are going to quickly find themselves in combat roles, but even if the initial move was repelled, the Islamic State has shown remarkable stubbornness in offensives against important bases, and Ayn al-Assad is probably going to be in their sights for some time. For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co. Reuters reports a law enforcement officer shot and wounded an inmate Friday evening during a confrontation in the restroom in the Dallas-Fort Worth International Airport, according to airport officials. Airport spokesman David McGonna said no flight schedules had been affected by the shooting inside the bathroom near Gate C-10, where the